The El Reno Indians, as we mentioned, they come in with a record of 2-6 overall. Let's give you their teams that they've the games they've played this year. They opened up with the 35-19 loss to Carl Albert. Carl Albert could finish fifth in that district. Howie, that's how good that district is with Guthrie and Deer Creek and some of those other teams over there. And then they went overtime and lost at Woodward, 34-27. And after that, they followed up with that big win over Western Heights, 31-26. Western Heights knocked off Deer Creek, if you remember. And it was a big district win for the Jets in that one. Then the Indians opened up district play with a 49-21 loss at Altus. Then they had the big win over Northwest Class, an 84-13. And then they've come into this game with a three-game losing streak, losing to Ardmore, 69-20, losing to Duncan, 42-7, and losing to Del City, 48-21. And for the Chicks, as again, they come in with a record of 1-7 tonight, and they opened up with a five-game losing streak, losing to Anadarko, 33-7, dropping a 44-16 decision to Noble, then losing 37-6 to Cash. In district play, they lost at Duncan, 48-7, then dropped a 45-13 decision to Ardmore. Then came their lone win at Taft Stadium, where they beat Northwest Classham 54-14. And the Chicks come in with a two-game losing streak tonight, dropping a 54-20 decision to Altus a couple of weeks ago. And then last week, the 57-6 decision to Lawton Mack. So they're going to face a different offense tonight, are the Chicks. They've been tackling an option game for the most part, but tonight a more traditional form of offense, as we've talked about in the pregame.
Yeah, it's going to be – it's interesting. If you look at the district, we're talking about all the teams that are really good, and one of the teams that does not actually run the flex bone is Lawton Mack, and they run more of an up-tempo college-style offense where they spread them out and then run the ball every once in a while. El Reno is going to come, and they're going to be a more balanced attack. Duncan, Ardmore, and Altus run a similar flexbone style of offense that the Fighting Chicks are running, so it's going to be a little bit different tonight for them. And I will say one thing about the flexbone. When you defend it, it seems like you have to do a whole lot more. There's a lot more people that can have the ball at one time, so it may be a little bit easier. As we head down to the field to John Mulder for our coin toss.
He was to the players here, and then he's going to ask me to step in. So it is a little drier here in the middle of the field than what I expected, and it looks like most of the moisture is on the sideline, so that bodes well for these young men.
Our coin toss, the presentation of Farmers Insurance Group agent Tom Cook, downtown Chickasha, with rewards for drivers that are accident-free. See Tom Cook, Farmers Insurance Group, downtown Chickasha, 5th and Chickasha Avenue. Our officiating crew tonight, by the way, a referee is Colby Miller, umpire Alfred Young, back judge Mickey Lockhart, linesman Rex Uthier, and the line judge David Tuck. We've seen
this. Here's the tail.
Down to John.
There's a head. El Reno, you guys are going to be calling it. Who's going to be calling it? 51, you're going to call it. What are you going to call?
Heads.
What did he say?
Heads.
If I drop it, we'll do it again. It is heads. El Reno, you won the toss. You want the ball.
So the Indians win the toss, and they will go on offense first here to get things going here on a soggy Memorial Stadium here. And the Fighting Chicks will guard the north goal to our left, and El Reno the south goal to our right. Not much wind tonight, John and Howie, so that may or may not play a factor.
Yeah, I think the kicking game is going to be a key tonight, John, because of the conditions of the field. We've been seeing some different things from the Fighting Chicks on long snaps, and I think that you could see maybe a big play on special teams tonight, John.
Yeah, I think you're right. You know, Chickasha's pretty good to be able to kick the ball deep within the end zone and keep them at bay there. But on the return game, we've had a little bit of trouble with the pooch kick and that sort of thing, and that could wreak havoc tonight as well, especially with these slippery conditions. And then obviously punting the ball. We need to make sure we secure that snap and get a good clean snap and give Xavier or whoever the punter is back there time to get the ball off and see what happens.
Let's take a timeout, and we'll be back with more in a moment. This has been the Sonic pregame from Memorial Stadium. Fighting Chicks, El Reno Indians, coming up next here on the 106.1, The Ranch.
In this country, we love liberty. And in Chickasha, we love Liberty Drug.
Experience a pleasant small-town atmosphere and Chickasha's only old-fashioned soda fountain. Enjoy a drink while you wait. And take a look at Liberty's boutique t-shirts from Jadelyn Brook and Charlie Southern. Liberty Drug is family-owned and operated and features Salt Lake candles, fun holiday decor, and a local pharmacist you can count on. Compare their service and your wait. Copay remains the same. Go Fightin' Chicks from Liberty Drug. Open weeknights till 6 and Saturday until 4:30.
You go online to get one of those quick auto quotes, but which coverage amounts are right for you? What about protection for your home, furniture, and other stuff? Major confusion. Then you find an independent insurance agent who gives you expert advice on all the home and auto insurance protection you need from the member companies of Ohio Casualty Group. Major relief.
Millett Hunter Insurance. Call 224-5402 or stop by the Millett Hunter Agency at 5th in Minnesota. Millett Hunter, committed to legendary service.
Bystead 220. For more on these and other great properties, call Chickasha Realty, 224-4298.
Go. We're back at Memorial Stadium, and let's go ahead and check tonight's starting lineups. Brought to you by the Chickasha Clinic Pharmacy. See Lacey or Lisa for all your prescriptions. Most insurance accepted at the Chickasha Clinic Pharmacy next to Southern Plains Medical Center. Let's check the El Reno offense, since they'll have the football first. Their quarterback, a senior, Taylor Hawkersmith. At running back, his name is Hunter Kometseva. He's a sophomore, Howie. They just call him Comet. So we'll see how he goes. At tailback, Nick Smith, he's a senior. And two seniors in the receiver position, Tony Evans and Cade Heilman. Along the offensive line, the center is Bo Denny. And the guards are Daniel Snow and Lino Rodriguez, all seniors. And the tackles, senior Josh Kastrop and junior Nick Stein. The Chick defense at nose guard, Damon Miller. Along the defensive line, Preston Phillips and Colin Stevens, both seniors. At defensive end, Justin Veach, a junior. Linebackers, Braden Blakes, Trace Brantley, both seniors, and Clayton Mosley, a junior. At corner, Jake Womack, a junior, and Brandon Russell, a senior. And at safety, Larry Abram, a sophomore, and Devin Pinkston, a senior. We do have Womack starting as a cornerback, but he has played a little bit of linebacker and defensive end lately, too.
Yeah, he's been moving all around the field. Still has the club on from the broken bone in his non-throwing hand. Well, he was the starting quarterback to start the year out, went down at Duncan, and has come back in and been able to play a role on the defensive side of the football. Something we've noticed the last couple of weeks is Braden Blakes hasn't been necessarily taking the main reps at running and he's looked a little fresher and a little quicker on defense. And so look for Braden Blakes to be flying around and making a lot of plays tonight. Also keep your ears out for those defensive linemen. They're really doing a good job down there.
Sterling Claffin, his final kickoff to start the game here. He's having surgery next week, so this is his final game as the Fighting Chicks. Game time temperature 52. Cloudy skies, no rain, and a slight breeze out of the north. Your John Holt kickoff from our left to right to get this game started. Week number 9, it's a high end-over-end kick, and it's going to be taken at the 5-yard line, and they sprint down the far sideline, breaking a tackle out to the 25, and the ball comes out. The Chicks say they've got it, and do they have the football? I believe
no. They
do not,
well, they
unfortunately.
Do. They do.
All right, the Chicks get a break on special teams to get the game started. A fumble recovery to get things started, and they are in great field position on the 25-yard line.
Yeah, that's a really great job down there. John, did you happen to see who was in on that tackle down there?
Number 18, I think, caused the hit. He's the one that had it right over the ball, guys.
That's Robert Ferguson, who's going to be playing quarterback tonight, but has been playing defense a little bit, so the Chicks get a break here to get things started. They have the ball first and 10 at the El Reno 25-yard line, going toward the south goal. And here is Robert Ferguson under center for the first time in quite some time. Brandon Russell is behind him at tailback, and the Chicks have two receivers to the near side with Jose Solano far to the wide side with Trace Brantley in the slot. First and 10, Chicks at the El Reno 25-yard line. Long snap count for Ferguson. It's the option play. The pitch to Russell gets a block, and he's down to the 20 and inside the 20. And a good gain on first down for Robert Ferguson.
Yeah, he picked up about 7 or 8 yards right there, and Robert Ferguson was the second-string quarterback. But he got hurt. There was a that was a bad couple of weeks right there for the Fighting Chicks early in the season. Good to see him back out there at quarterback.
Gain of six. So call it second and four from the El Reno 19. Blake goes to the right side this time. Russell going to be swallowed up there after a gain of about one down to the 18-yard line.
Number five for El Reno, Braxton Flick, was all over that play. Had that one clogged up right in the middle.
So call it third and a short three as the Chicks will bring David Thibodeau, who's been starting at quarterback. He sets up a flanker on the left side. And the Chicks, again, going no huddle as they've done all year with this new flexbone offense that Coach Jerry Don Bray has instituted. Ferguson goes over to Thibodeau to give him the verbal audible. Here's the option play. The ball comes out, and Ferguson's got a fall on it back at the 24-yard line. That'll be a loss of six.
That was the same young man there, Braxton Flick, number five for El Reno. Look to hear his name being called quite a bit tonight. He was all over the pitch right there. Robert Ferguson not able to do a whole lot with it. And the Fighting Chicks, well, looks like they're going to go for it here on fourth down and eight.
From the 24-yard line, trying to take advantage of the fumbled kickoff by El Reno. Opening series here for the Chicks. The ball is on the near side hash. Ferguson with a long snap count. Abram in motion, and they look to draw El Reno off sides, and they did.
They got it, and I think that might have been what Coach Bray was wanting to do. And he's done that a couple of times throughout the year, and they've done a good job, the offensive line, staying disciplined in that situation because it's real easy for that flag to go the other way if everybody's not paying attention down there.
So that takes the ball down to the 19-yard line, fourth and three. The Chicks have to get to inside the 16-yard line to continue the drive. 15 seconds on the play clock as they look to the offensive coordinator on the near side of the field. Now they check their wristbands, and here we go. Fourth down and three with Abram in motion right to left. It's a pass play to the near side, and there was a miscommunication between Ferguson and Solano. Solano was streaking toward the end zone, and Ferguson was expecting him to stop and maybe turn around at about the 15-yard line.
Yeah, but it looked like Robert Ferguson down there, John, wanted him to run the quick out, and Jose was running the post to the end zone.
Yeah, Coach. Coach is talking to the receiver right now. Saying to check his wristbands. He's trying to put him on the wrist.
So El Reno takes over on downs, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. No score, 9:48 to go here in the opening quarter. And there's a handoff to the tailback, stringing it out to the far side and getting 4 or 5 yards out past the 25 to about the 26-yard line. That's Hunter Baker, a junior running back that gets a good carry on first down.
Yeah, that was a good burst there for the El Reno Indians when they get the flip of possession right there, stopping the Fighting Chicks. Good burst over there by the running back and making a couple of guys miss. Fighting Chicks need to tighten down here. Second down and a long three, almost four.
This is Taylor Hawkersmith, the senior quarterback under center. A pro set, back to pass. He comes to the near side. It's caught out to the 31-yard line for the first time and breaking tackles out to the 38-yard line. Pass complete to Tony Evans, a senior, a big receiver, and he was left unchecked here on the near side of the field.
Yeah, that you can't let that happen too many times tonight, guys, or they're going to burn you deep. And he gets up with a little hitch in his giddy-up, and he just ran a short little out pattern in the flat. And when he went to plant, I noticed him slide a little bit and look for the footing to give way down there, John.
Gain of 13, so it's first and 10 El Reno at their own 30-yard line. They're going from our right to left as we're approaching 9 minutes to go in this first half of play. Chicks recovered a fumble on the opening kickoff, but they could not take advantage. Hawkersmith, the toss to the tailback, sweeping to the right side. He gets to the edge. He's out to the 45, and a nice tackle. Didn't quite get to the 45 over there, but the tackle made by Devin Pinkston for a gain of about three.
Yeah, good job over there by Devin Pinkston to control that and not let that one pop for a big gain. There was a huge block over there on the far side of the field on the right side of the El Reno offensive line. Basically a decleater, as John Madden would call it. Somebody came pulling on the inside and got one of our guys and blocked it and really broke that play out.
Cade Heilman splits to the far side at receiver, and Anthony Evans to the near side. Here's second and four, and the running back gets it, but he has stopped at the line of scrimmage, and a great tackle there by CHS.
It looks like Preston Phillips getting up right there from the tackle, number 50, one of the seniors tonight on senior night for CHS.
maybe a gain of a half a yard. They're going to spot it at the 44-yard line, so we'll call it third down and about six. They've got to get out to the 49-yard line to extend the series. No score. Opening quarter. Pro set behind Hockersmith. Third down and six. The Chick Show blitz. Back to pass Hockersmith. He throws short. It's going to be, looks like it's incomplete. It is near midfield. And looks like Clayton Mosley was in on the stop over there. David, let's see.
He had Devin Pinkston over there, Trace Brantley, and then he had Braden Blake sit all up in the quarterback's face mask, having him get rid of that one early. That was a great defensive down right there for the Fighting Chicks, and that'll bring up a fourth down and five, almost six. Looks like about a fourth down and six for the El Reno Indians, and they have the punting unit in.
Looks like it's the Nick Smith back to punt. Jose Solano back at about his 20-yard line, kicking into a bit of a breeze here. It's a low snap, and it's going to be a short kick. Solano coming to his left is going to take a sideways bounce inside the 30, and it'll be down by El Reno at the Chick 29-yard line. 7:39 to go, opening quarter, and we've had the two teams exchange possessions with no score.
Yeah. Need to see the Fighting Chicks put a drive together right here. They had great field position on their last possession and turned that one over on downs. John looking to see them to get something going down here.
Chicks going from our left to right, and here's Ferguson under center. Man in motion is Thibodeau. They're going to go right. It's going to be an option play, and Ferguson keeps it. He's over to the past the 35-yard line. A good misdirection play by Ferguson, faked a handoff to Russell, and a great play and a good gain on first down.
About a gain of 9 yards down there, and that's kind of what we were wanting to see from Ferguson earlier in the year before he got injured, and he's just got a little bit of a different step down there.
Second down, nine from the Chick 37-yard line. Abram in motion right to left. They're going to give it to Ferguson. Keep it once again. He's got the first down out past the 40 to about the 41-yard line before the El Reno Indians stand him up. So the Chicks get their initial first down.
Yeah, great job. The coaches saw something on the El Reno defense keying on Brandon Russell. And so they're just having Bob Ferguson hang on to it here a couple of times and picks up some good yardage.
First and 10, Chicks at their own 42-yard line. Thibodeau in motion, and Thibodeau's going to get the toss to the 40, gets to the edge of the 45, out to the 50-yard line, and spins into El Reno territory. Got a block on the edge near side, John Mulder, and a big first down for David Thibodeau.
Yes, sir. Nice-looking run down here. You could tell he wanted to make the plan a little bit quicker, but the slippery footing, especially over here near the midfield mark over on the sideline, it is pretty slick over here, guys. Coaches, players, personnel, everybody's sliding around.
Gain of 11 for Thibodeau. First and 10, Chicks at the El Reno 47. No score yet. Midway through this first quarter of play. Four-man front for El Reno. Abram in motion, right to left. There's the option play. Ferguson keeps it to the 45. 40 gets a block to the 35. 30, he's to the 25. And spun down about the inside the 20-yard line. Robert Ferguson gives the Chicks another red zone possession here on a great run.
Shoulda, coulda, woulda, what could have happened, or if this young man would have been healthy earlier in the year. Making some great reads over there, hanging on to that one and not pitching it. Has seen something in this El Reno defense. The coaches have telling Mr. Ferguson to hang on to the ball because you are open to run it, my man.
Gain of 29. First and 10 Chicks from the El Reno 18. Again, trying to break the ice in the ball game. Thibodeau in motion left to right, and they try to get the ball to Russell, but there's a little mix-up in transition. Ferguson's going to go down. He's going to lose about a yard back to the 19.
Yeah, I like the look of this Chickasha offense with Robert Ferguson in there at quarterback. He's got a quick step, and our quarterback for most of the season out there, Mr. Thibodeau, number four, he's lined up as a wing back. And so you've got some weapons out there in the backfield that he can distribute the ball to, and he is a weapon himself.
Second and 11 for the Chicks back at the 19-yard line. Two receivers left for Ferguson. 5:32 to go here in this opening quarter of play, and no score. The Fighting Chicks recovered. There's a high snap over the head of Brandon Russell. He picks it up, and he's going to try to give it to Thibodeau, and Thibodeau doesn't know what to do with it. He's dropped back at the 30-yard line, a loss of 11 on that broken play.
Go ahead, John.
Guys, that was a designed call, but with the muffled snap right there, you wish the youngster just would have held onto the ball and tried to see what he could make of it. You don't want to put it on the ground too often. Fortunate we were able to get back with that. Of course, we got about 3rd and 20, it looks like.
Yeah, they got to get to about the 11-yard line. The ball is at the 29. So 3rd down, Chicks going from our left to right. Ferguson in abandoned motion. Ferguson on the option play. A bad toss. The ball is on the ground, and Thibodeau's got to jump on it just to maintain possession.
That was ugly. The snap that John was trying to describe, they had the flex bone set up there, but Robert Ferguson was just to the side of the center, and it was basically a wildcat formation, if you're familiar with that in college football, and they were going to snap it straight back to Brandon Russell, and that was kind of fumbled, and then we had another fumble right here on a snap, and El Reno's getting some penetration in there and is forcing a couple of bad decisions by the Fighting Chicks.
It is 4th and 25. They're going to send Clapton in for a field goal attempt. They're going to spot the ball at the 39. This has got a 49-yard field goal attempt. A bit of a breeze at his back. 4:06 to go. Ferguson's the holder. A good snap. A good hold. And the kick's got the ball did not get down very good. And Ferguson's got to pick it up. The kick was not blocked. But I think Ferguson mishandled the wet ball, and Sterling never did get a foot on it.
Sterling never was able to plant, John, is what I saw. Is that what you saw down there?
Yeah, a little bit of both. I mean, the number 4 did get a body on it, but it wasn't going anywhere. It didn't have to be blocked, but it was. It's really slippery down here. You saw Bob kind of wiping off his hands before he went to make the snap. I think with him playing quarterback and being out there, we're going to have to send him a towel if we're going to try a field goal from that length again.
El Reno has it for the second time in the ballgame. Scoreless with 3:54 to go first quarter. Here's Hawker Smith under center at the El Reno 39-yard line. And there's the handoff. The Chicks got to have it stopped and dropped for a loss. Back at the 24-yard line, Braden Blake's on the tackle on Hunter Baker.
Braden Blake's is an explosive linebacker, and when he's got enough juice in the tank like he's had in the last couple of weeks, not having to take the load of running back on the offensive side of the ball, look for him to be in the backfield making things happen tonight. We'll be calling his name quite a bit.
By the way, our pregame meal tonight brought to you by Jake's Rib. Thanks to Ron and Mary Eaton and Red and the gang. Some great ribs and chopped barbecue and Polish sausage. And holy cow, we had the beans and the coleslaw and the Okie fries. The pass is intercepted by the Chicks. Did he get it?
He dropped it.
He was right in his arms and just couldn't quite hang on to it. Braden Blake's,
I think,
almost had an Oski.
Braden Blake's almost had one. He's saying, that was my bad. I think he was more surprised that the ball was in his breadbasket than the quarterback for El Reno was. And the Fighting Chick defense is looking pretty decent down there. They've got a 3rd down and about 16 situation here. And look for them to apply some pressure to the quarterback.
Hawker Smith under center. The running back is about 10 yards behind him. Back to passes. Hawker Smith rolling left. Not much pressure. He's going to throw it into one-on-one coverage. It's going to be too long, and it's going to be 4th down, and we've got that's going to be Tony Evans, who's been a little bit hampered a little bit. We see him limping off the field.
Guys, Tony Evans is their big receiver.
Yeah.
Sorry, George.
He's
their big target down there, and you're right. He is limping quite a bit. He drive off of his foot. It was very obvious that he's not 100% on that play.
Yeah, it goes all the way back to that very first play, John, they targeted him on. He went to plant and cut, and it didn't happen. And ever since that first play, he's got a little bit of a limp going on over there.
3:02 to go, first quarter, and back to punt is Nick Smith and Jose Solano back inside the Chick 35-yard line. A good snap, but the ball is going to be kicked along the ground. I don't know if it's a live ball or not. The Chicks just need to fall on it. They do it about the 50-yard line. The kicker just got the end of the football and just kind of dribbled along the ground for about 10 yards, Howie, before the Chicks are able to pounce on it.
We talked about the kicking game being an issue tonight, and there could be some big plays. And, George, that was a live ball. One of the Fighting Chicks got a hand on it, and so at that point the kicking team could have recovered that. And good job by the Fighting Chicks to get on top of that one. It's going to be a little bit of a messy, sloppy night tonight.
No score, 2:53 to go, first quarter. Chicks have the ball at midfield. Ferguson facing what's basically a 5-man front, a 3-down lineman, and 2 on the end, as the Chicks have had the ball in the red zone twice but unable to score. Brandon Russell is the tailback behind Ferguson. Russell's going to it's going to be the option play. The toss is complete to Abram. He gets to the 45-yard line before it's dragged down from behind and a flag comes in. So we've got laundry on the field, and we definitely need to take that to Nana Sue's tonight with all the mud and blood and all that going on down there. Open 7 days a week, Nana Sue's, with heavy-duty washers and dryers, an automatic door for your convenience, and vending machines on site. Nana Sue's Laundromat Chickasha at 3rd and Dakota, across from Small Engine Service.
That's going to be a holding against the Fighting Chicks, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, so that'll be a first down and 15 here for the Fighting Chicks on that one. And she's going to have some bleach if she's going to want to get any of these uniforms clean after this one.
No kidding. The ball marks back 10 from the spot, so back to the Chick 45-yard line, first and 15. Thibodeau in motion left to right, then he stops just as he gets behind the tailback Russell with 13 seconds left on the play clock. Now they're going to bring Abram. He comes over to the side to sideline to try to get the call. Now with 5 seconds to go on the play clock, Ferguson under center, Thibodeau in motion, and they're going to give it to the toss to the tailback. He's to midfield and into El Reno territory.
As Larry Abram over there on the carry and picking up a good chunk of yardage. Looked a lot like the play that they had the holding called on him on the play before, and they're noticing something over there on the left side of that El Reno defense.
Gain of 8, so call it second down, and about 7 from the El Reno 47. We're under 2 minutes to go in the quarter, and no score. A cool and soggy evening tonight. No rain. That quit about 5 o'clock this afternoon here in the Chickasha area. Second and 7. Ferguson, and they try to hand it off, and right there, the El Reno defenders are right there to meet him as the Ferguson tried to keep the ball in the breadbasket of Brandon Russell, and El Reno stops it. Matter of fact, they throw him for a loss back to midfield, a loss of about 3.
Yeah, that was trying to switch out balls down here, too. I can guarantee that that ball is nice and soggy and wet, and it's going to be, as the game wears on, that's going to be a challenge as Jake Womack gets spelled out. He's in there with that broken left hand, bone in his left hand, and been in there playing tight end for the Fighting Chicks.
Third and 10 for the Chicks at midfield. Solano split to the near side. Brantley split to the far side. With a minute to go here in the quarter and no score, 10 seconds left on the play clock. Ferguson wipes his hands on his pants. Now under center. And the option play, and the ball is on the ground, and it's going to be picked up at the 45-yard line. Then it comes loose and should have just fell on the ball and to keep possession. Can't tell if El Reno's recovered yet or not, and they have.
Well, that's a backbreaker right there. That's the probably their best starting field position of the night. That's going to be on the Fighting Chick 44-yard line. It'll be a first down and 10 for the El Reno Indians. That was a tough one. That one was ugly from the get-go. El Reno's getting some real good penetration down there, John, into that Chickasha backfield.
Yes, they are. And you can tell our line's getting a little wore out. Number 5. We know we've been calling his name most of the night, but he's playing lights out. We got to keep an eye on him.
That's Braxton Flick, and he's just a junior. So El Reno, first and 10 at the Chick 44-yard line. Scoreless game. Final minute of the first quarter. Screen pass is complete, and the Chicks stopping for a little gain to the Chick 41-yard line.
I tell you what.
Thibodeau with the tackle.
Braden Blake's almost intercepted the screen pass. He came flying from his outside linebacker's position and got his arms up in the air, and I guarantee he could feel the football underneath his armpits on that play.
Gain of 3 down to the Chick 41-yard line. El Reno does not have to run a play if they do not want to. 10 seconds to go in the quarter with 16 seconds on the play clock. They do run a play. They get it to the tailback. He goes up the middle. He's flung down for a loss, and what great work there by our good friend Braden Blakes.
He's having a stellar senior night so far, as that brings us to the end of the first quarter. Chickasha El Reno scoreless. You're listening to the Fighting Chicks on 106.
Business owners, you're inundated with salespeople selling you on why Bear Media is better than the guy that just left your office 5 minutes ago. Most of you understand the importance of radio advertising, but you're looking for avenues that will enhance your ad campaigns. Outdoor is the answer. Strategically placed billboards capture a large audience, and it's the most inexpensive per impression form of media available. Find out how billboards can create more awareness of your product. Call Moment Outdoor at 224-1604.
see this badge? Of course not. It's radio. It says Train Comfort Specialist. It means we're expert technicians and as reliable as the train systems we install, keeping your winters cozy and summers cool. And when you do see this badge, you'll immediately feel more comfortable.
Introduce your home's heat and air system to the heat and air experts at Ben Milam at 224-4314. That's 224-4314.
It's hard to stop a Train Comfort Specialist.
Community. Community Bank of Oklahoma. Member FDIC.
We start the second quarter, a scoreless tie. El Reno has the ball. Third and 11 from the Chick 45-yard line. Now going from our left to right as Hockersmith goes under center. Four-man defensive front for the Chicks. Back to pass with some pressure. Bubble screen is incomplete. The Chicks got some pressure on them. Jake Womack back there as well as Preston Phillips.
Yeah, good job there by the Chickasha defense. They're playing lights out tonight, doing a great effort down there. Fourth down and 11 now for El Reno. And here comes the most interesting part of the game tonight, John, the kicking game.
Yeah, going back to that last play, Blakes was there again and had it slipped on this wet turf out there. Fortunately, the screen pass wasn't effective as they dropped the ball. But you're right, Howie. George is going to have to keep his A game on to accurately describe the way these kicking games go off.
Junior Rojas is back to punt inside his 45-yard line. We've got a flag down, and I think we've got to delay a game here, Howie.
Yeah, that looks like zero's on the play clock, and that'll back him up 5 yards. And I'm sure we'll take the yardage any way we can get it.
Rojas injured a bit. Coach Wes Brower said he was injured in playing club soccer and is able to rejoin the club. So that'll move the ball back near midfield, and that'll give Rojas a little more room to work with. But Jose Solano inside his 25-yard line. High snap back to him, and the Chicks might have gotten back there, but it's a good punt, and it's going to go out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. No return.
Guess who's back there about to block a punt? Braden Blakes, number 11. The Chicks have seen something on film on the El Reno punting. They have been coming after him tonight, not necessarily bringing the house, but they're getting some guys back there around the punter. It'll be a first down and 10 for the Fighting Chicks at the 25-yard line of their own 25-yard line.
Some first quarter stats. Chickasha, 33 total yards. El Reno, 19. Each had a turnover. The Chicks with 3 first downs. El Reno with just 1. Chicks have it first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. We're scoreless in the early moments of the second quarter at Memorial Stadium. Robert Ferguson under center with 2 receivers left. It's Ferguson on the keeper right up the middle. And he's going to get 2 or 3 yards. Going to spot him at about the 28-yard line, a gain of 3.
33, Taylor Smith for El Reno in on that tackle from his linebacker position. Fighting Chicks are doing a pretty decent job down there on offense, trying to get something going.
Second and 7 from their own 28. And there's the option play. It's Braden Blakes trying to pick up some yardage past the 30.
That's Robert Ferguson.
Robert, okay.
Braden Blakes is down there leading the way and picking up just a little bit off of the Chickasha right side of the offense on the far side of the field. Brings up a small 3rd down and 3, and that's just exactly where this offense needs to be at for the running game.
A good spot for Ferguson out to about the 33-yard line. They've got to get out to the 35 for the first down. Chicks have had 2 red zone possessions in the first quarter but could not convert. Ball in the middle of the field. Ferguson is under center, 2 receivers right. And they fake the option, but Ferguson keeps it, and he is going to be very close to the first down. The linesman has him right at the 35-yard line. That should be enough to move the chains.
Yeah, the linesman looks like he gave him forward progress, but they spot it just short, and they're going to measure. They're going to take time out for a measurement here, and the nose of the football is short of the chalk on the 35-yard line. This will be an interesting measurement.
Guys, one of the things you get with Bob Ferguson, and he's just got a nose for the football on defense, as I like to say. But you notice there's a busted play, and he just takes the ball, lowers his head, and picks up a few positive yards that more than likely is going to get the Chicks the first down here.
10:45 to go, second quarter, and they're going to be just short, unfortunately, John, about 3 or 4 chain lengths. So it's going to make it 4th down, and the Chicks have been moving the ball pretty well. So let's see. It looks like they're going to go for it here. No score, nothing to lose. Neither team going to the playoffs, but just playing for a little bit of pride. And the Chicks would love to get a home victory this year. They've not been able to do that here in 2015.
Yeah, I look for him to just go straight up the gut here, quarterback keeper. What I would do, just keep it in the chest of your quarterback.
Ferguson under center. Receivers left and right on fourth and short for the Chicks from their own 35. And they easily get the first down. Colin Stevens just following the center. As Ferguson just follows Stevenson right up the middle, and it's a gain of almost 5 yards out to the 39-yard line.
Yeah, they picked up more yards right there than they did on third down, and that's a great job down there by the offensive line, creating a massive hole for the quarterback to get through, picking up a first down, first one of the second quarter for the Fighting Chicks.
And the fourth overall for the team from their own 39-yard line. Abram in motion, and Ferguson back to pass. He's going to go deep, but that's kind of like a wounded duck. But fortunately, nobody could catch it. The pass was intended for Jose Solano, but a flag is down in the Chick backfield. Holding is the penalty, is the indication against the Chicks.
That was ugly. Robert almost tripped coming out of the pocket, and El Reno was crashing down hard. And that's just going to be I'm trying to keep my quarterback from getting tattooed penalty down there.
Our coverage of CHS football, a presentation of Community Bank of Oklahoma, Southern Plains Medical Center, as well as Joe's Maytag. No score, 10:15 to go here in the opening quarter. Some other scores to pass along. Lawton Mack over Dell City, 7-0. Ardmore is leading Northwest Classen, 20-0. Clinton over Woodward, 14-7. Our thanks to our good friend Mark Fleming, listening in the Dallas area on our website. Thanks, Mark. We appreciate you tuning in. It is first down and about 20 for CHS back at their own 30-yard line. Here's the toss sweep to Abram. He's to the 30-yard line and tripped up at about the 34-yard line. Great tackle there by Dallin Keene to prevent a bigger gain.
Oh, yeah. Larry Abram, he got up and he was shaking his hands saying, man, if he wouldn't have tripped me up right there, I'd have kept going. And he had some clear sailing if it not for that shoestring tackle there by El Reno. Second down and about 15 now for the Fighting Chicks.
Yeah, that was a gain of 4 there for Abram. Solano will split to the far side of the field. Brantley to the near side on this second down 15 play. No score. In motion is Denver Calhoun. They fake the toss sweep to him, and Ferguson rolls left. He gets a pass complete to...
guess who?
Braden Blakes. He's got a big first down inside El Reno territory, inside the 40. What a great play there, John Mulder.
Yes, sir, he did. He had a chance to step out of bounds, and a guy like him is not going to do that. He got every yard he could, about 5 yards after contact. Braden Blakes is playing very well tonight.
Hey, can you check on Brandon Russell down there? He's looks like he's holding his arm down there, John, and quarterback Robert Ferguson had two guys open in the pattern on that one as El Reno takes a timeout.
30-yard gain on the play. We'll step aside as well. No score, Chickasha, El Reno, 9:27 to go in the first half. You're listening to the Fighting Chicks on 106.
High school sports are among the many extracurricular programs that our students participate in. They learn important skills like teamwork, determination, communication, and sportsmanship. This is State Representative David Perryman. My wife, Jo, and I support students throughout the area and encourage those same characteristics in the classroom and to achieve high academic goals for the common good of all. If you have questions or ideas to share about issues at the state capitol, I encourage you to give me a call.
From blazing heat to freezing cold, Oklahoma's weather can wreak havoc on your home comfort system. Keep your system in shape with regularly scheduled routine maintenance from DeHart Air Conditioning. Their certified specialists can take care of any issue affecting the performance of your home comfort system, keep it in shape, and fend off the sudden shifts in weather. Ensure a comfortable home with reliable maintenance from DeHart Air Conditioning. Call now, 224-0184.
Fighting Chicks have it first and 10 at the El Reno 36-yard line after that 30-yard pass play to Braden Blakes. Ball on the near side hash. Thibodeau in motion right to left. They're going to give it to Braden Blakes, who lined up at tailback. He's inside the 35 to about the 33-yard line. Let's see if we can get an update about Brandon Russell from John Mulder. John?
Yeah, you know, it's a little bit slippery down here on the ball that he, across the field, he fumbled on. He tweaked something just a little bit. Coach has pulled him out. They're trying something a little bit different, but I think he's okay. His number will be called here pretty soon.
Injury timeout brought to you by Dr. Chris Ledwell and the Ledwell Chiropractic Clinic. Man in motion is Denver Calhoun. They're going to give it to Brandon. That's Brandon Blakes. They're getting my B's mixed up there, and he stutter steps out to the near side, and he's inside the 30 to about the 27, about a yard short of the first down.
Hey, he's made a good cut down there, and if that field wasn't so mushy, he'd probably still be running and doing a touchdown dance. He had some good running room back to the near side of the field as they're checking on the side here to change the play with 19:18 on the play clock.
This drive starting on the Chick 25-yard line, the ninth play of the drive, third and one, and they're going to give it to Blakes. He's got the first down and more inside the 25, down about the 22-yard line.
This will bring up a first down, and we need to remember that they also went for it on a fourth down and inches play with a big hole up the middle with Robert Ferguson. They're seeing something up the middle now, and they're going with Braden Blakes up the middle a couple of times here in a row and picking up some good yardage for a Fighting Chick first down at the 22-yard line.
Going from our right to left, again, the Chicks had two red zone possessions. They recovered the opening fumble on the opening kickoff, but could not score after turning it over on downs. And then Sterling Claffin could not get a 49-yard field goal attempt away. Here's the toss sweep to Thibodeau. He's caught in the backfield. He'll be thrown for a loss back at about the 25.
Man, he had just a little bit of something there, and then it closed up in a hurry. And El Reno's all over it up there. He got number 12 coming in from his position, Jason Holmes, the senior. And a couple of other guys over there for El Reno helping out and clogging that hold up over there for the Fighting Chicks.
Going to be second down and 12 now with 7:34 to go in the half. No score. Chicks trying to break the ice. Ball on the far side hash. Trace Brantley checked in the ball game for Jake Womack. And Brantley split out to the near side. Braden Blake still the tailback. Thibodeau in motion. They play action. The pass comes back to the near side low. And some pressure applied by El Reno, and Ferguson had to throw the football before he wanted to. Unfortunately, Blakes just couldn't get there.
Yeah, that was a tough one all the way around. It was a tough throw for Robert Ferguson to get off, and that's one of those I can't stand the option play where the quarterback drops back and he turns completely to his right and then twists around the opposite direction back to his left. It loses a lot of time right there, but I know that is exactly the way it's designed up. Designed to look like a running play, and then the incompletion pass there on second down.
That's how Braden Blakes had that big 30-yard pass play before. Here's third and long. Ferguson on the option play. Gets a block to the edge, to the 20, and he's going to be stopped short of the first down, but he had plenty of real estate over there, John.
Yes, he did, and he saw something, and the coaches are telling him to look to run the ball first before the pitch, of course, with being slippery conditions out there on the edge. Bad things can happen if you don't execute the pitch correctly.
We have an El Reno player down on the far sideline. It's going to be fourth down and about three for CHS. Another red zone possession here, their third of the game. And we're going to have an official timeout with the injury to the El Reno player. Injury timeout. If you're hurt playing sports or suffer a work-related injury, see Dr. Chris Ledwell at Ledwell Chiropractic and Sports Rehab. Now featuring Advocare products. Also providing B12 and other injections. Ludwell Chiropractic and Sports Rehab in Chickasha's Crystal Grand Plaza. That's at 12th and Grand. John, what do you have?
Howie, back to that that play that you were talking about where the quarterback turns around. One of the disadvantages that we have with our third option at quarterback here is he hasn't had a lot of reps there with the slippery field conditions, and Bob's not the tallest guy out there. The footwork and the timing on that are vitally important, so I tend to agree with you, but Coach Bray has not been able to run the offense that he has wanted to this year because of all the muff snaps. So I think he's taking every opportunity he can to pull them out of his playbook.
Fourth and three, Chicks from the El Reno 15-yard line. Thibodeau in motion. Here's the option play. The toss is bobbled, and they're not going to make it. They try to get the option play to Thibodeau, and it's going to be dropped for a loss of about 4 yards. The Chicks turn it over on downs again in the red zone. 6:27 to go in the first half and no score.
With the field conditions the way they are, some people are probably thinking, well, why didn't you line up for a field goal? You're down there on the 19-20 yard line. But the field goal the kicking game right now, it doesn't matter who's out there kicking it. You could have Uwe von Schaumann out there trying to kick the thing, and it would be a very interesting adventure at best. And so going for it right there, Robert Ferguson was getting lit up when he was getting rid of that pitch. That was a tough one to do.
Makes El Reno go a long way here. First and 10 from about their own 20-yard line. Running play to the near side, breaking some tackles, and finally spun down at about the 24-yard line. And looks like Devin Pixton finally brought him down. That was Hunter Komet-Siva, or Komet, as we said we'd call him, and picks up a pretty good gain on first down.
Yeah, that was tough running depth back there. We had some guys in position, and just, you know, by the time these guys have been on the ground five or six times, their uniform is nice and wet, and they're even more slippery than they are when they're bone dry. So tough to bring them down with an arm tackle, and Fighting Chicks are going to have to bring some people to the ball.
Gain of seven, so it is second and three. El Reno, 5:51 to go before halftime. Hawker Smith with the option play to the tailback and looking for some blockers, but the Chicks are going to look like they had him stopped for a moment, and he's going to get some positive yardage. He's going to be short of the first down. That is a Komet in there on the carry, spotted at the 28-yard line.
Got Ty Thompson and Braden Blake's in there on the stop on the far side of the field, and El Reno's trying to get something going here. They've got a third down and one at the Fighting Chick 29-yard line.
But only one first down for El Reno so far tonight. Manageable here as Hawker Smith goes under center. They give it to the tailback, and he's ahead for the first down. And a good tackle there by Braden Blakes. Otherwise, the Komet would have been off and running. Gain of about 5 yards out to the 34-yard line.
Man, that was that right where you wanted him. You wanted to get a big stop right there, but you got to keep going. First down and 10 here for El Reno. Ty Thompson in there on the defensive line, spelling looks like he's spelling Colin Stevens.
First and 10 from the El Reno 34-yard line. Hawker Smith back to pass, too high, intended on the near side for Kate Heilman, and a nice stop there by Brandon Russell.
He came in with that clean, pretty white uniform just for that play.
Yeah.
Brandon Russell lit him up and made sure he knew he was playing football tonight, and that uniform is no longer white.
And we're good to see Brandon Russell back in the ball game after sitting out for a few plays. Incomplete pass makes it second down and 10. El Reno, no score, under 5 minutes to go before halftime in a wet field here, but no rain. Second and 10 from the Chick 35. That's the toss sweep to the Komet, breaking tackles, and brought down, though, behind the line of scrimmage.
Looks like Kobe Powell over there on the stop, number 65, but the first guy through the line is Preston Phillips, whacking himself on the helmet, getting up because he ran right by the running back down there, John.
Yes, sir. That was pretty good execution by a lot of the Fighting Chicks. We haven't seen a lot of swarm tackling this year, but we did on that play. Nice job of the defense.
Loss of one, so call it third down 11 at the El Reno 33-yard line. And again, that big receiver, Cade Heilman, back in there, splitting to the near side with a man in the slot. Third and 11, El Reno back to passes. Hawker Smith under some pressure. Middle screen is complete, but the Chicks are there to stop it. I don't know if it's complete. If it is, it's going to be a loss of yardage.
Yeah, they're calling it complete right there. Ty Thompson, number 54, was basically on the receiver's back. That was one that you don't want to catch. You just want to bat that one to the ground. But that's a good job there by the Fighting Chicks. Fourth down and 15 for the El Reno Indians, and the punting adventure will continue.
It was a loss of three on the completed pass, so fourth and about 13 from the 30. Rojas back to punt, and Solano back at about the Chick 40-yard line. 3.5 minutes to go, and it's going to be a short kick, and it's going to take a sideways bounce, then rolls Chickasha's direction a couple of yards before it's finally downed by El Reno. And the Chicks have the ball near midfield with 3:24 to go before halftime and no score.
It is. It's just a sloppy mess down there right now. You try to get something going in the running game, and you try to make a cut, and your cleats give out, and then you try to get something going in the passing game, and the quarterback tries to plant, and there's nothing there to plant on. So it'll be an interesting game as the field conditions deteriorate.
Fifth possession for the Chicks. First and 10 at their own 48-yard line. They went 60 yards on their last possession before turning the ball over on downs at the 15-yard line. Thibodeau in motion. Screen pass batted down. No, it's complete, but nope, incomplete. Boy, somebody got a big paw up there. I believe that was for El Reno, Bo Denny.
Man, that one looked ugly from the get-go. That was a real quick quick little screen pass, basically a long handoff down here to Trace Brantley. And if Trace would have been able to hang on to that one, the trajectory got altered a little bit. But if he'd have been able to hang on to that, could have done some damage.
Second and 10 near midfield. Again, Thibodeau in motion. And they give it to Brandon Russell over the right side, breaking tackles inside the 45 to the 40, still going to the 35 and 30, brought down inside the 30-yard line. They had him stopped at the line of scrimmage, but he kept going, and Brandon Russell with his biggest run of the ball game.
And he's down, guys. He's hurt. He was out the first part of the year with a high ankle sprain, and he came down just a little bit awkward down there, John.
Yes, he did. And, he was just itching to get in there and get his opportunity on a run as they were running it up the middle, and his number was called, and hopefully he's okay, because he was just itching to get his chance to shine. And a pretty good run on that one. You saw his speed.
About a 27-yard gain, and credit to blocking. Looked like El Reno had it stopped initially, Howie, but the Chicks kept blocking, and that opened up a hole for Russell, who exploded for 27. But we do have an injury timeout with 3:10 to go in the first quarter. So first half, rather. We'll step aside. El Reno and Chickasha scoreless. You're listening to the Fighting Chicks on 106.
Hey, dude, will you toss me a Dr. Pepper?
Here you go.
What is this?
A bottle of soda.
Did I ask for a bottle of soda?
Well,
no! I asked for an ice-cold, delicious Dr. Pepper. This is not a Dr. Pepper. Dr. Pepper is like throwing a game-winning Hail Mary. Other sodas are like punting on third down. This so-called soda is sillier than a mascot in a marching band. So when I ask for an ice-cold bottle of Dr. Pepper to watch football with, the one-of-a-kind taste of Dr. Pepper is what I demand. Dr. Pepper, always one-of-a-kind.
Try the honey barbecue, garlic parmesan, or buffalo wings. For a great deal on Sonic wings, stop by any Monday from 5 p.m. to close for buy one, get one free wings. Sonic of Chickasha also has half-price burgers every Tuesday after 5. And be sure to get a Route 44 Coca-Cola. Sonic is also your morning drink stop with half-price drinks until 10 a.m. and half-price drinks again during happy hour each day from 2 to 4. This is how you Sonic.
After the injury timeout, first and 10 Chickasha from the El Reno 25-yard line. Option play for Robert Ferguson. Picks up about 5 yards, but a flag is down. Brandon Russell able to limp off the field with some help, but definitely favoring, I believe, his right ankle.
Howie. Yeah, that was tough down there. We got a flag on the play down there, and Anna Sue's going to be busy a little bit tonight, not only with the uniforms, but with the and we've got a chop block on the Fighting Chicks, and that'll back that one up quite a bit. And I'm surprised we haven't seen more flags for holding and for illegal blocking because of the footing, and your offensive linemen are trying to hold their ground, and the ground beneath their feet's giving up, and so they're just reaching out and trying to do anything they can to keep the defense from coming across.
First major infraction of the game for either team. It's a 15-yard penalty against CHS. They'll mark it back to the 40-yard line. It'll still be first down, but first down and 25. Some other scores to pass along. Anadarko 22, Newcastle nothing at Warrior Field, and Altus over Duncan 7-0. First and 25 Chicks at the El Reno 40-yard line. Scoreless game. Final 3 minutes of the half. They give it to a big Clayton Mosley getting his first carry of the game, and inside the 30 to about the 28-yard line, gain of 12.
You'd like to see, this old-fashioned football. You give it to the big guy, let him go north and south and take a big chunk of yardage off of the gain to go over there. It brings up a second down and 10, a little bit more familiar territory than that third and first and extremely long.
So they get all the penalty back on that 15-yard carry by Mosley. Second and 10. And they're going to give it right up the middle, and for gain inside the 25-yard line. Couldn't tell
that's
who that
Clayton,
was.
That's Mosley again. They've got given Braden Blakes a little breather over here on the sideline as he's been in there. Him and Brandon Russell have been sharing the halfback duties. And in the backfield, you've got Larry Abram and David Thibodeau and Clayton Mosley in the backfield.
Gain of 5, so third and 5 for the Chicks. From the El Reno 23, trying to score the first half. And they give it to Mosley up the middle. No, it's an option play for Ferguson, and he's got the first down. Marking it about the 15-yard line.
Yeah, it's going to be a first down and 10 there for the Fighting Chicks. Move the chains, and good job down there. They've been hammering it up the middle with Clayton Mosley, and then they fake it to Clayton, and Robert Ferguson picks up a good chunk of yardage off of the right side of the offensive line.
A minute 32 to go, scoreless. Chicks have 2 timeouts left. This drive starting at the Chick 48-yard line. Ferguson under center. Thibodeau in motion. It's the option play. Ferguson keeps it, gets a block, and a short yardage gain, maybe to about the 12-yard line, where it's going to be second down at about 8 as we approach 1 minute to go in the half, scoreless.
I'd like to see the Chicks get this one into the end zone and don't want to have to see them. They've got still got 3 timeouts over there, and look for Jerry Don Bray to start taking a timeout here pretty soon after they pick up this second down.
Trace Brantley split wide left. Jose Solano to the far side with the 45 seconds to go. Second and 8 from the El Reno 13-yard line. Play goes to the right, and there is Braden Blakes. Gets to the edge and runs out of bounds at about the 10-yard line. Maybe he may have just gotten back to the line of scrimmage. That'll stop the clock. It was just under 33 seconds to go.
Looked like they gave him about a half a yard to gain over there on the far side of the field with 32.8 left on the clock before half.
Brandon Russell getting his right ankle taped up on the near sideline, so hopefully he'll be able to be back in the second half. As Howie mentioned, Chicks have all 3 of their timeouts remaining. Ferguson under center on 3rd and 8, option play left, and they're going to go up the middle, and we're going to have a timeout for the Chicks with 28.4 seconds to go. Short gain on the play, and it's going to be 4th down when we come back from the timeout. We'll just keep it right here, though, and let you know that CHS football, a presentation of Wing Tees, Chicken Clinic Pharmacy, and Ben Milam Air Conditioning. Coming up at halftime, Howie, we'll give you a quick bio of all the 21 seniors on this Fighting Chick Club, so we'll be reading fast.
Definitely. There's a lot of them down there. They were stretched all the way across the field earlier down there with their families and brothers and sisters and moms and dads, and even some of them had grandma and grandpa down there. And special night for all the seniors tonight, and all the ones that are out there suited up. Some of them are hurt, but all the ones that are got pads on, you know they're going to give it everything they've got down there, John.
And that's been the message that the coaches were sending to the seniors. Let's let it all hang out. And you see Bob Ferguson and Braden Blakes, and you can kind of see they've got a little more giddy up in their step tonight. And it's carried over. You see Preston Phillips in on a few plays. I mean, these guys want to win this game. They're taking pride in playing on their home field, going out on senior night. It's important to them, and it'd be nice to get in the end zone on this play.
Going for it on 4th down again. They've yet to convert a 4th down yet here tonight, and this is another their 4th red zone possession, 4th and 7 from the 12. Thibodeau in motion, and the Chicks come out of the set to get the play. It's the customary to do that. Now 10 seconds left on the play clock. Abram in motion now. They fake the toss left. Rolling right is Ferguson looking for a receiver. Throws, and it's going to be tipped and intercepted by El Reno, but inside the 5-yard line.
If Robert wouldn't have been running for his life, he had a guy wide open on the goal line. Looked like Trace Brantley was down there running free, and then Jose Solano. But Braden Blakes was short. Tried to get it over the top of Braden Blakes and dump it off down in there to the guy on the goal line. But that was a tough, tough throw, and he's not in the end zone. They're going to call that a 1st down and 10 for El Reno at the fight at their own 2-yard line. And a tough break right there for the Fighting Chicks.
Well, John, let's see if the defense can play strong here with a wet field at the 2-yard line. Maybe we can maybe get a safety here as the quarterback for El Reno, Hawkersmith, under center on 1st and 10 from the 2, and they give it to the tailback, and it's a safe play. He gets some positive yardage, works it out to about the 5-yard line, and that's probably going to be the end of the first half. It will be. It's been a wet field and no scoring, although the Chicks have had 4 red zone possessions that have come up empty all 4 times. But 0-0. Chickasha and El Reno, and John Mulder's going to chase down Coach Jerry Don Bray here momentarily. It's been a very, very good first half. Chickasha holding El Reno to just 2 first downs. Go ahead, John.
Coach, sloppy conditions out there, but a pretty clean game on both sides. Not many penalties. A lot of sliding around out there. Your seniors are playing with a little jump in their step. I like the way Blakes and Bob are flying around.
man, they're getting after it. I'll tell you what, defensively, I mean, Coach Mulder had a great game plan coming in, and these guys are executing to perfection. I don't know how many times they punted, but they don't have very many first downs. They punted four or five times, and offensively, we're moving the ball like crazy. We just can't punch in the zone for whatever reason. The penalties backed us up or putting the ball on the ground or not being able to execute on fourth down. So we got to get that straight and get some points on the board.
We had a fumble early, but the snaps looked to be clean, and that's saying something in these field conditions that we have tonight.
Yeah, there's no question. I mean, it's slicker than heck out here. The guys are doing everything we ask them to do, flying around, and what a great time to be a Chickasha football player and play this night on these conditions against a good football team in El Reno and playing well.
Kind of like playing in our backyard when we were kids, huh?
You didn't do that.
Well, I think you did.
No, you weren't tough enough. You couldn't play with me.
Good luck, Coach.
All right, Coach, and thanks to John Mulder. Of course, Coach Mulder is Joe, John's brother, of course. So great exchange there. So, wow, what a great first half here. 0-0, Chickasha El Reno. And we'll be back with a quick recap of the first half, and we'll brag about the senior players for the Fighting Chicks when our coverage continues in a moment here on 106.1 The Ranch.
Jake's Rib is Chickasha's premier barbecue restaurant. They've been serving up generous portions of delicious barbecue for 30 years and invite you and your family and your sports teams to stop in for heaping portions of hickory smoked ribs, sliced beef and pork, pulled pork, as well as steaks, chicken, and fish. Check out their daily specials and be sure to save room for cobbler. Ask Jake's about catering your special event. Jake's Rib, the only barbecue restaurant in Chickasha, open 7 days a week.
John Holt and Chickasha, where the deals are real and the prices are low. John Holt and Chickasha, when it comes to cars and trucks, John knows the only place to go for the best deal is John Holt. John Holt Chevrolet, where the hottest thing to do is pick your favorite color. John Holt and Chickasha.
From burgers and breakfast to chicken and ice cream, your Chickasha Sonic Drive-In has what you want when you want it. From the regular Sonic Burger to the Super Sonic Bacon Double Cheeseburger and the Chili Cheese Little Doggy to the Footlong Chili Cheese Dog. From a Route 44 Coca-Cola to the Kevin Durant Candy Slushes and a Simple Sundae to the Chillin' Sonic Blast, Sonic has you covered. Still with half-price soft drinks during happy hour every day from 2 to 4. This is how you Sonic.
Southern Plains Medical Center, SPMC, has been providing quality health care to the residents of Southwest Oklahoma for 100 years. And SPMC offers general surgery, internal medicine, lab and radiology, and many other services that others cannot offer anymore. In Anadarko, the Physicians Hospital offers Caddo County residents health care and vision care with the Advanced Eye Center in downtown Anadarko. Together, Southern Plains Medical Center and the Physicians Hospital Anadarko, proudly serving the residents of Grady and Caddo counties.
Chess Memorial Stadium, Chickasha nothing and El Reno nothing. It's what's been an entertaining game. Not as many turnovers as you might expect in the wet conditions, Howie.
Yeah, it's just it's tough sledding down there. It's hard to hang on to the ball. It's hard to pitch the ball. It's hard to catch the ball. I'm surprised we haven't seen more actual turnovers. We've put the ball on the ground a little bit tonight and need to start forcing El Reno to put the ball on the ground a little bit more too.
Let's give you a recap of the first half. El Reno won the toss and elected to take the football, only they fumbled the opening kickoff, Howie. The Chicks recovered at the 25-yard line but could not score. They got to the 18-yard line, went for it on fourth down, and ended up turning the ball over on downs. El Reno did get the ball and picked up one first down before got out to about midfield before they kicked the football away. The Chicks got the ball at their own 28-yard line with about 7.5 minutes to go in the quarter and put together a pretty good drive. We picked up three first downs and got down to the El Reno 33-yard line. They went for it. Is that when they tried to get the field goal on their second possession?
Second possession, I believe, was the field
That's
goal.
Right.
And that was Sterling was unable to plant, and Robert Ferguson was pretty much unable to grab the ball. That was the kicking game. We'd mentioned it coming in before the game started is going to be crucial.
So the turn it over on downs. El Reno gets the ball with about 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. They go three plays and out. The Chicks get the ball at midfield, and they run four plays and fumble the ball back to El Reno with about 37 seconds to go. El Reno ran a couple plays, and it was a scoreless first quarter. El Reno would end up kicking the football away. Two plays into the second quarter, the Chicks put together their best drive of the game from their 25 down to the El Reno 15-yard line. That included one fourth down conversion that I failed to mention before, but fourth and short, and they got good yardage on that. Then they got a 30-yard pass play to really get inside El Reno territory.
Yeah, when we have time to pass, we've had some guys running open down the field. The tough part is giving Robert Ferguson enough time to find those guys downfield, and he found Braden Blakes on that one for a 30-yard reception.
Again, the Chicks could not convert on fourth down from the El Reno 15-yard line, so the Indians took over with about 6.5 minutes to go, picked up just their second first down on that drive, moved out to about the 30-yard line before kicking the football away. The Chicks again got great field position near midfield with 3:24 to go, and they got down inside the 15-yard line, had fourth and seven from the 12-yard line. Robert Ferguson scrambling, trying to find somebody open, ends up throwing what was basically a meaningless interception. El Reno took over at the 2-yard line with 19 seconds to go, ran the clock out, and that's been the first half. Two turnovers for the Chicks, one for El Reno, just two downs for El Reno, eight first downs for the.
Yeah, it's been a quick first half. I was just looking down at my watch, and I'm thinking, wow, it's been pretty quick. And
an hour.
1 hour, and we got a half a football behind us.
So it's 0-0 Chickasha El Reno. We'll take a break, and we'll be back with some scores, and we'll also talk about those seniors when we return here on 106.1 The Ranch.
What's the first thing you notice when you walk into an Arvest?
When I come in and they call me by name.
Half of the people there call me Aunt Bliss.
Even the branches that I don't go in a lot, you know, usually I get a greeting.
When you get off work, you want to see happy people.
They always say good morning or good afternoon.
They answer everything I need.
I enjoy seeing my family at Arvest at any time.
When I'm running late and you think you're not going to make it and those doors are still open here, it's a relief.
Arvest Bank, our customers say it best. Member FDIC.
Wish you could undo your Verizon or AT&T contract? Just bring your bill to a U.S. Cellular store, and we guarantee we'll beat your current plan price. If we can't, you'll get a $50 promo card. Retail installment contract, share connect plan, phone turn-in, $25 activation fee, and device protection plus required. Must port in number from Verizon or AT&T on comparable share data plan. $50 U.S. Cellular promo card issued by MetaBank, member FDIC, valid for purchase in-store or online. Other restrictions apply. See store for details.
Sells You More has all the devices to keep you and your family connected no matter where you are. Sells You More, your U.S. Cellular authorized agent. Check out our Chickasha location at 1714 South First.
Come see us at Sells You More.
Chickasha's Clinic Pharmacy, a locally owned Health Mart pharmacy, is a proud supporter of Fightin' Chick football. Flu season is approaching, and now is the time to get your flu shot at the Clinic Pharmacy. With low competitive prices, accepting most insurances, close to doctor's offices, and with a drive-thru, Chickasha Clinic Pharmacy can also answer any questions you have. Just call 224-4851. Health Mart pharmacies are locally owned pharmacies like Chickasha's Clinic Pharmacy, caring for you and about you.
High school sports are among the many extracurricular programs that our students participate in. They learn important skills like teamwork, determination, communication, and sportsmanship. This is State Representative David Perryman. My wife, Jo, and I support students throughout the area and encourage those same characteristics in the classroom and to achieve high academic goals for the common good of all. If you have questions or ideas to share about issues at the state capitol, I encourage you to give me a call.
From blazing heat to freezing cold, Oklahoma's weather can wreak havoc on your home comfort system. Keep your system in shape with regularly scheduled routine maintenance from DeHart Air Conditioning. Their certified specialists can take care of any issue affecting the performance of your home comfort system, keep it in shape, and fend off the sudden shifts in weather. Ensure a comfortable home with reliable maintenance from DeHart Air Conditioning. Call now, 224-0184.
The Clinton Red Tornadoes over Woodward, 21-7, and Elk City 7 cashed nothing at halftime. Also, Dibble leading Lexington 7-0 in the first quarter. That's this week's National Guard game of the week at Lexington.
Yeah, that's an interesting score down there. Lindsay Leopards will be off this week. They will have their final home or their final game against Walters next week. And so, if you don't hear a Lindsay score, that's why. They are off this week.
And that game with Walters next week is for home field advantage in the first round of the playoffs. Walters lost at Washington last night, which gave Walters the district championship. So Lindsay and Walters each have one district loss to Washington. So the winner of that Lindsay-Walters game will get home field advantage in the first round. Walters was unbeaten hosted Washington last night.
Lindsay Leopards were unbeaten before they faced Washington. So that's a little tough little conference over there.
No doubt. All right, let's check out some of the seniors. We've got 21 to mention, and we've got some short bios. And Ohio, why don't you get started?
Braden Blakes is the son of Sonya, and his siblings are Tanika and Nakentra. His favorite football memory is when he beat Coach Corbin in one-on-one in basketball, and I've actually played him, and Braden's good.
Yes, he is.
He's salty. His future plans are to play college football and become a coach.
And Trace Brantley, the son of Les Brantley and Misa Mitchison, and his siblings are Jared, Nikki, Valerie, and Caitlin. Trace's favorite football memory, his 70-yard pick six, and turning around to see Robert Ferguson running harder than he was just to celebrate with him. Trace's future plans to attend OU and pursue a career in engineering.
Denver Calhoun is the son of Jeff and Stephanie and John Burns. His siblings are Ethan, Haley, and Maddie. His favorite football memory is coming back and playing football with my boys. Denver's future plans are to attend Choctaw Firefighter School and become a firefighter.
Next, Jason Cash, who is a new player to the Fighting Chicks this year. He's the son of David Cash, the superintendent, also Carolyn and Julie. His siblings are Andrew, William, and Cody. His favorite football memory is when Coach Bray asked Jimmy if football was fun. Jason's future plans are to go to college and get a job.
Adam Kaysen is the son of Scott and Angie. And brother Brian, he has his favorite football memory is the whole year bonding with the team and seeing everyone become brothers. His future plans are to attend Okmulgee Tech Center and to become a diesel technician.
Sterling Claffin, the son of Monty and Christy. His siblings are Dalton and Paris. And Sterling's favorite football memory, his sophomore year in the playoffs, last time Chicks went to postseason, he kicked the longest field goal of his career against Guthrie at Jelsma Stadium. So that's a great moment for that young man. He wants to attend college and also wants to kick once he gets to college, and I'm sure he'll get that opportunity.
Yeah, he's a good soccer player as well.
Yes, he is.
He's having surgery on his knee to see if he can get healed up for soccer season. Dale Courtney is a son of Craig and Robin, his sister's Sarah. His favorite football memory is when Coach Mulder shows us just how much he misses and loves the game of football by lining up with us. John, take some notes on that one from your brother. His future plans are to serve a combat medic in the U.S. Army.
Damon Miller, the next senior, his parents are Aunt and Uncle Cheryl and James Anderson. His favorite football memory, when he convinced his cousin Jimmy Don Miller to join the football team. Damon wants to attend OSU and get a degree in mechanical engineering and minor in petroleum engineering.
There's a future for that bright young man. Robert Ferguson is the son of Cindy. His siblings are Carrie, Ryan, Colt, Macy, and Mimi. His favorite football memory is my team, my family, coming together through all the hardships that he's faced this year. And Robert's future plans are to attend college and get a degree in elementary education.
Wants to teach the youngsters. Sean Jacobson is the son of Alan and Catherine. His siblings are Samantha, Jonathan, and Colton. One of his favorite football memories when he placed in his very first powerlifting meet. Sean wants to serve in the U.S. military and live a life as a soldier.
That's an excellent plans for Sean Jacobson. Dao Jean Lim, his parents are Ming Tong and Sylvia Ho. His siblings are Su Xiang, Dao Tong, Dao Kai, and Dao Hong. His favorite football memory is racing everyone on the football team for the Gatorade after practice. His future plans are to attend college at USAO and major in business and become an accountant.
Anthony Utatavi is the next senior. His parents are Lena and Sato. His sister is Melody. His favorite football memory, making it to the playoffs his sophomore year. He also wants to attend USAO.
Preston Phillips, his parents are John and Angie. His siblings are Jonathan and Aspen. His favorite football memory is the lineman dinners at his house.
Ooh, I bet so.
I would imagine. Preston's future plans are to attend USAO and to get a degree in something and he can use to run cattle.
Devin Pinkston. His parents are Kimberly and Mike. His siblings are Ty, Tim, and Dawson. His favorite football memory is playing football with Damon Miller in Pee Wee football. He wants to attend college in UCO and study criminology.
Brandon Russell is the son of Brandon and Grandma Donna Eco. His favorite football memory is going to Jose's dad's house, Coach Glover, with teammates, and also running behind his warthogs, the offensive line, Damon, Colin, James, Jason, Anthony, and Preston. And Brandon's future plans are to attend college.
Nick Sales is a guy we don't talk about a whole lot, but he's a senior on this club. His parents are Nikki and Beth, and his siblings are Nathan and Berkeley. And his favorite memory is going to linebacker dinners. His future plans are to attend college and to be an engineer.
His parent, Jose Solano Jr., is our next senior. His parents are Jose and Concepcion, and his siblings are Giovanni, Tanya, and Lucy. His favorite football memory is when Brandon Shumway was throwing him lots of touchdown passes in eighth grade. I wish Shumway was out here right now him out. He's a good athlete. Jose's future plans are to attend UCO and to get a degree in mechanical engineering.
Colin Stevens is next. His parents are Mark and Leslie. His sister is Colby. And his favorite football memory is the linebacker dinners. He wants to become a mechanical engineer as well.
Lots of engineers in this class. Good for these guys. TJ Wicks, his parents are Tom and Laura, and his brother is Jimmy. His favorite football memory is making it to the playoffs his sophomore year. TJ's future plans are to attend Concordia University and become a youth pastor.
Well done. Javier Willits is the next senior. His parents are Tony and Misty, and his siblings are Alyssa and Gerald. His favorite football memory is running out of the ready room before home games. His future plans are to attend college at either OBU or OCU, and he also wants to become a youth minister.
And then we've got a couple of managers to recognize. Amy Schuler is the daughter of Sheila. His aunt, her aunt and uncle Jeannie, and Philip Vandell, and her siblings are Stacy, Christy, Kristeny Vinson, Caleb, and Chris. She has been a football manager for 6 years. That's a long time. Her favorite football memory is playing in the JV game just a couple of weeks ago against Piedmont and deflecting a touchdown pass.
Way to go, Amy.
Good job, Amy Schuler. Her future plans are to attend OBU and go into ministry and be a missionary.
Well done. And the other senior manager is Kristeny Vinson, and her parents are Denise Castillo, Chris Vinson, Aunt Sarah, and siblings are Kelly, Fury, and Amy Schuler, Aaron, Dakota, Blake, and Wilkerson. She's been a football manager for 7 years, and her favorite football memory is when Coach Bray asked her to be a manager way back in fifth grade. She wants to attend OSU and become a veterinarian.
Senior cheerleaders, are we going to go in? Do we have time to go into those,
sure.
George? Okay. Madison Paige Arthur is the daughter of Robert and Stacy. His siblings are Kyle and his fiance Shaylee and Allison. Her favorite cheer memory is winning regionals her junior year, and Maddie's future plans are to attend college and to major in pediatrics and later become a pediatric nurse.
Katie Sue Cyphers, the daughter of James and Gina. Her brother is AJ, and her favorite memory is finally hitting her stunt at state and the constant dance parties they have at cheer practice. She wants to attend college to become a physician's assistant and work in pediatric medicine.
Kaylee Warden is the daughter of Kevin and Missy, and siblings are Cade and Carson. Her favorite cheer memory is going to Dallas for nationals every year with the team. Kaylee's future plans are to attend Oklahoma Christian University and study nursing and become a nurse practitioner.
And let's check the Palm Chicks while we've got a minute, including Katie Lee Fever, the granddaughter of John and Marilyn Fever. Her parents are Medea and Daniel White. Her favorite memory, trips to Oklahoma State dance competitions. She will attend USAO. Why not? Her grandfather's the president there. And then go to OU Science and Health Center for occupational therapy.
Pages are sticking together.
Yeah.
Next Palm Chick is Taylor Lene Lessig. She is the daughter of Paul and Lacey, and her siblings are Lauren and Cameron. Her favorite Palm memory is making the All-Region dance team, and her future plans are to attend UCO and major in nursing.
And next is Ivy McPherson, the daughter of Mark and Lisa. Her sister is Faith. Her favorite memory, when all the Palm coaches did the red nose at Palm Camp on the fence, when the team finished state runner-up at Palm State her sophomore year, she wants to attend OSU.
Mallory Mottinger is the daughter of Eric and Michelle, and her favorite Palm memory is her junior year when her and Bailey Ogle saw a skunk pop up from beneath the stadium, and Bailey jumped on her back, and she ran across the track. Mallory's future plans are to attend Oklahoma Christian University and then attend law school.
And Bailey McKenzie Ogle is the daughter of Eddie and Wendy. Her sister is Ashlyn. Her favorite memory is every performance with the team. She wants to go to OU and then medical school.
Leah Price is the daughter of Stacy. The siblings are Brianna, Haley, Tiana, Lauren, and Kimberly. And her favorite POM memory is when her cousin Katie called a chant at the Northwest Classen game and then forgot the words, and it made the whole team and the crowd laugh. Leah's future plans are become an LPN and become a certified ultrasound tech, and sometime in there, get married to Zachary Ashby.
All right. That's a salute to all of our seniors, the players, the POM chicks, and the cheerleaders. We'll take a break, and we'll be back with second half action in a moment. Chickasha nothing, El Reno nothing. You're listening to the Fightin' Chicks on 106.
Chickasha Realty, matching quality people with quality homes. Here's a beautiful three-bedroom home at 802 South 12th. There's an above-ground pool, a putting green, and three baths. It's priced at $184.5. Or see this adorable starter home at 711 South 18th. Two beds, one bath, with hardwood floors, large rooms, and plenty of storage, now just $74,000. For more on these and other great properties, call Chickasha Realty, 224-4298.
New in the local banking industry. It's the Community Bank of Oklahoma, which now serves the Chickasha, Verdon, and Newcastle areas. While the name is new, the bank's operated by your friends and neighbors whose families live here. They support local schools, sports, and ag programs, along with projects and activities that benefit their communities. Featuring a full line of banking services, Community Bank of Oklahoma provides competitive rates and unequaled service. Looking forward to being part of a thriving community. Community Bank of Oklahoma, member FDIC.
Wondering what to do over the next 2 years and beyond? Let Canadian Valley Technology Center give you a jump start on your education. Whether you plan to go on to college or immediately enter the workforce after high school, Canadian Valley is your ticket to a successful career. No matter where your interests lie, health, computers, transportation, or engineering, Canadian Valley has something for everyone. You can even earn college credit in many of our full-time programs. So sophomores, get ready. We'll be by your high school very soon. Canadian Valley Technology Center, securing futures.
High school sports are among the many extracurricular programs that our students participate in. They learn important skills like teamwork, determination, communication, and sportsmanship. This is State Representative David Perryman. My wife, Joe, and I support students throughout the area and encourage those same characteristics in the classroom and to achieve high academic goals for the common good of all. If you have questions or ideas to share about issues at the state capitol, I encourage you to give me a call.
From blazing heat to freezing cold, Oklahoma's weather can wreak havoc on your home comfort system. Keep your system in shape with regularly scheduled routine maintenance from DeHart Air Conditioning. Their certified specialists can take care of any issue affecting the performance of your home comfort system, keep it in shape, and fend off the sudden shifts in weather. Ensure a comfortable home with reliable maintenance from DeHart Air Conditioning. Call now, 224-0184.
Regular season game. They are district champs regardless of what happens at Glenpool tonight. It's 2-0 at halftime. The Tigers lead that one.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of, we were talking about that in the break, there's going to be a lot of weird scores tonight with field conditions much like what we have here at Memorial Stadium in Chickasha. Sloppy and muddy, and you know that they were, somebody was pinned deep in their own end zone, and you know, probably a something bad happened, so you're going to see some weird scores tonight.
Lawton Mack 30, Dell City nothing. Lawton Mack will seal up the district championship if that continues. Clinton over Woodward 21-7. Altus over Duncan 14-0. That's a second quarter score. The Fighting Chicks will have the football to start the second half, and they have won the battle of field position, John Mulder, but they just can't find the end zone.
They have, and, you know, these kickoffs always make me nervous. Solano and the guys back there, they want to pick it up and score with it, and sometimes a smart thing to do is just get all the field position you can and jump on the ball. So, as we've said all night, let's kick it off, and it should be interesting.
Yeah, El Reno was in their huddle for quite a while out there, so look for something sneaky here, either a short pooch like Lawton Mack did last week or a true onside. Watch for something weird.
A score for our videographer, Dennis Lynam. Marlowe and Lone Grove are tied at 7, and Dibble leads Lexington 13-0 in the second quarter. To kick off, Junior Rojas for El Reno, kicking from our right to left into a bit of a breeze. We've had no rain during the game, but 2 inches here earlier today has made conditions very, very slippery. Solano is standing at about his 10-yard line as Rojas tried to situate the ball on the 40-yard line. They are looking to get the onside kick here. The John Hope kickoff from our right to left, and it's going to be a high pooch kick going toward the far sidelines. The Chicks call a fair catch, and it is caught at the 36-yard line.
Call for a fair catch and got hit over there, did Devin Pinkston. When he calls for that fair catch, he's got to be given a clear line of sight to the football, and that might be what this one is.
There is a flag down there, and it's going to be against the Chicks. Did I see a delay of game or something?
They called for illegal use of hands, John. Go ahead.
You know, Howie, what you saw coming in there, I think it was a block by the Chicks, and that may have rushed the El Reno guy into him, but I think it should have just been a no call right there. I guess they haven't been able to use the laundry most of the night, so they want to use one on that one.
So the Chicks will have the football, but they'll have it first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. I have 8 first downs for the Chicks, only 2 for El Reno. Robert Ferguson under center, and he's done pretty well after not playing there for most of the season. The senior trying to make something happen in a scoreless ball game to start the second half of play, going from our left to right. The big guy gets through. That's Braden Blakes, and he powers forward to about the 34-yard line, a gain of 9. John, get us an update on Brandon Russell, too, if you could.
Yeah, he's
down here in the sideline.
Talked to him at halftime, and he was in quite a bit of pain. Of course, he had a nice run there pretty late in the quarter and then came up with a high ankle sprain, which he's battled all year.
But still in uniform. Here's a second and short play, and it's Braden Blakes on the first down and carry, and Moore gets past the 40 to about the 41-yard line before being brought down by one of the El Reno defenders there. And on the tackle was the very game Tony Evans, who's been playing with a bad ankle today.
George, real quick on back to Brandon Russell. He and the other running backs have a little friendly wager on who's going to be the first to break one loose, so he wants in on that action.
All right, first and 10 Chicks. Here's Braden Blakes once again up the middle, out past the 45 to about the 46-yard line.
Brought down over here on the near side by looks like number 51, Bo Denny, the senior for the El Reno Indians, and just trying to get something going here. Good-looking drive to start out the second half.
Well, the Chicks have been able to move the ball between the 20s, Howie and John, but they've just not been able to get the ball score in the end zone. 0-4 in red zone possession. Second and 4 Chicks with Abram in motion. Back to pass Ferguson. He's going to throw deep to Solano, and he just can't quite make the catch. He had his defender beat, and the ball was just a bit overthrown. Solano tried to make a one-handed grab, Howie, but couldn't quite make it.
And if the field's dry, he's where he's supposed to be on that one. That was a timing route all the way. Robert Ferguson put that one up in the air and throwing to a spot on the field. And, man, I wanted that one to be complete, I think, more than they did. A third down and 5 here for the Fighting Chicks.
At the Chick 47-yard line with a slight breeze at their back, not much. So here we go, facing a 5-man front. Thibodeau in motion. They give it to Blakes. Nope, it's going to be Ferguson on the keeper. And somehow David Thibodeau comes up with the football, and he's going to be pushed out of bounds at about the original line of scrimmage. So it's going to be 4th down and about 4 for CHS.
Looks like they're going to go ahead and send in the punting unit. Javier Willett's coming in to attempt the punt here on 4th down and 4. Coach Bray wants to pin him deep and make him earn it. And I can't say as I blame him, but let's see if we can. This will be I believe this will be Chickasha's first punt. Is that correct?
I believe so.
Have gone for it on fourth down quite a few times and only made it once.
Xavier Willits inside his 35-yard line. Let's hope for a good snap. It's going to be a low snap. They were going to fake it. They snapped it to Clayton Mosley, but a whistle comes in before the snap. So they had the fake going.
Oh, offsides.
Offsides.
That's going to be close to a first down, depending on the mark down there, John.
Yes, it was, guys. But I have a feeling there that Mosley was about to break that one loose. There didn't seem to be anybody around him. So we'll take the good where we can get it first down for the Fighting Chicks. But, man, we need a touchdown.
All right. That would have been so the Chicks able to draw them off sides, and they move the chains. Another fourth down conversion, and it's first and 10 at the El Reno 49-yard line in a scoreless game, 10 minutes to go in the third quarter. Solano split wide left. Blake's in the backfield. And they give it to Blake's. He's forward for about three, maybe four, down to the 45-yard line.
Guys, still some pretty slippery exchanges down there. I've seen it a couple of times. Bob's kind of bobbled the ball, but fortunately we've been able to contain it for the most part and pick up a few positive yards.
He came up with that one, John, right around his face mask before Braden Blake's grabbed it from him.
Call it second and seven from just outside the 45-yard line.
Changing the play, getting the play called in from the sideline. Everybody's checking their armbands here on second down and six.
One receiver to the far side on the second down play. They give it to Blake's, and it's a keeper by Ferguson. He's got the first down and more to the 35 and 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, and touchdown!
That was a beautiful, beautiful play as I'm up here celebrating just like everybody else in the stands. And they were hammering up the middle, and everybody thought Braden Blake's, including us, had the football. Robert Ferguson, John, breaks off the outside. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. You know, we've commented about it a few times tonight where he's got kind of a nose where he'll just stick it up there and run, and faked it to Blake's and stuck it up and went away with the score. Nice block by Solano on the edge there to spring it for the touchdown.
46-yard touchdown run. Here's the extra point attempt. It's on the way, and it is no good. Wide left for Sterling Claffin. 9:07 to go in the third, and the Chicks break the ice. They lead it 6-0 over El Reno. You're listening to the Fighting Chicks on 106.
If you're one of the millions of Americans who suffer from lower back pain, MotionWorks Physical Therapy can help. Researchers have learned that motor control exercises can help strengthen muscles that support and control the spine. MotionWorks can show you how to get those muscles working properly and relieve low back pain. For more than 10 years, MotionWorks has been helping people just like you recuperate from illness or injury with a customized rehab program. MotionWorks of Chickasha. Call 224-WORK. At MotionWorks, they work for your health.
Tired of fighting with bargain brand lawn equipment? Then step up to Echo Power Equipment at Small Engine Service in Chickasha for your next grass trimmer, power blower, chainsaw, or tree trimmer. Only Echo is built pro-grade and is backed by the industry's 5-year consumer warranty. Don't let the words pro-grade scare you. Echo is affordable, starting at under $160. For a limited time, the Echo SRM 225 grass trimmer, just $199. When it's time for mowing, you should be going to Small Engine Service, 3rd and Dakota, Chickasha.
MotionWorks Physical Therapy and sells you more. Sterling Claffin on for the John Holt kickoff from our left to right. The Fighting Chicks on the scoreboard on a 75-yard touchdown drive to open up the second half 6-0. Claffin's kick right down the middle, and it is going to be returnable inside the 5-yard line. They take it to the far sideline to the Indians. Gets to the edge of the 25 and 30, 35, down to the 40, 45. The Chicks finally drop them at the Chickasha 44-yard line. A great return for that young man.
Trace Brantley over there on the stop, and Sterling Claffin combining for a touchdown saving tackle over there. A little bit of a breakdown in the special teams by the Fighting Chicks. They've only had to kick it off one time tonight, and that return was fumbled. And so they haven't had to be out there a whole lot in kickoff coverage, and El Reno comes up with a big gainer on the kick return. Be a first down and 10 at the Fighting Chick 44-yard line.
About a 40.
You could almost see that from the opening. It didn't look good for the Fighting Chicks. It was set up well for the Indians, and they took advantage of it with a great field position.
First and 10, El Reno at the Chick 46-yard line. Going from our right to left now. Hawker Smith under center, man in motion right to left. There's the toss sweep to the tailback and breaks through the line of scrimmage, and the Fighting Chicks are going to get him. Mosley is in there for the tackle. Devin Pinkston, too. Maybe a gain of one.
Yeah, David Thibodeau was the first one to get a hand on him in the backfield coming from his cornerback position, and Fighting Chick defense is flying around all over down there for a no gain. Brings up a second down and 10.
That touchdown drive for the Chicks, 75 yards, 2 minutes, 53 seconds, and 8 plays. It included a fourth down conversion when El Reno jumped off sides on 4th and 4. And the 46-yard touchdown run, Robert Ferguson. Second down play, and there's the pass going to be complete. Short yardage, though, and he makes the first guy miss, and that's that big receiver, Cade Heilman, but the Fighting Chicks gang tackle him after a short gain of about 4 to the 40-yard line.
Man, that was they barely got that pass off, George. We had a couple of Fighting Chicks down there all up in the quarterback's face and making him get rid of it a lot earlier than he wanted to for a third down and 6.
Indians put a man to the wide side of the field. That's Dylan Goddard, a senior receiver. And to the near side, we've got Tony Evans. Third and 6. There's a running play. The fight just going to stop it. Clayton Mosley, a tackle for loss.
That was a big play down there by Clayton Mosley, number 44, coming in. And their big receiver was down here on the near side of the field, Tony Evans. And good job by the Fighting Chicks to stay honest and stay home. Fourth down and 9 here for El Reno, and looks like they're going to go for it.
Loss of 3 there as Mosley broke free to get Hunter Baker on a TFL. 7:13 to go in the third. Chicks lead 6-0, and here's a fourth down and 9 for El Reno at the Chick 43-yard line. Receivers left and right for Hawkersmith. Chicks are going to jump, not off sides, back to pass Hawkersmith. The pass is going to be, what a great catch for the first down. That was a great catch by Tony Evans.
Larry Abram gave up on that route just a little bit there. That one was kind of on him, and he's going, oh, coach, what did I do? Great route there by number 22 from El Reno, Tony Evans. Nothing short of him. That young man has a chance to play at the next level, whether he walks on or gets a scholarship somewhere. He's got some talent.
Gain of 10 on fourth down. So first and 10, El Reno at the Chick 33-yard line. The ball comes out, and the ball is on the ground, and it's going to be picked up by El Reno. And the Chicks are there to make the tackle, Braden Blakes, but it's going to be a loss on the play. The Hunter Baker was able to pick up the football, but Braden Blakes made sure he wasn't going to make any forward progress. It's going to be a loss of about 3 back to the 36-yard line.
That was tough. We talked about it. We called for it at halftime. We need El Reno to put the ball on the carpet a little bit more. There's one for one so far. We just weren't able to get on that one.
Second and 13. Chicks up 6-0. Hawkersmith under center. Wants to screen pass. He's going to be hit from behind Braden Blakes. Sacked back at the 40.
I've got a nominee list so far tonight for player of the game. Most of them are seniors for the CHS Fighting Chicks. And Braden Blake's there with a huge play to bring up a third down and 16 for the El Reno Indians.
He broke through there pretty fast there, John.
Yeah, it was a blitz call, and he took full advantage of it. Guys, I mean, I know I sound like a broken record here, but he has developed into quite a football player, and I hope he gets a shot to play at the next level as well.
Third and 16 from the Chick 40. A 39-yard line. Hawkersmith, screen pass, going to be incomplete. And Abram breaking up the play.
Abram almost took that one the other way. I'll tell you what, they're just inches away down there, John, from big plays.
Yes, they are. You know, and Larry's a youngster down there, hasn't got a lot of playing time at the corner position, but plays hard, not in the best position all the time, still kind of learning the ropes, but, you know, you'll take the effort when you're not in the right position. So I think they're happy with the result.
Fourth and 16. This time, El Reno looks to punt as junior Rojas is back at about midfield with Jose Solano back at about his 10-yard line. 5:18 to go in the third, and Chicks leading 6-0. Fourth down. Not much wind here at Memorial Stadium this evening. Rojas gets a low snap, gets a good kick away. And giving chase to Solano. He should have let it bounce into the end zone. He fields it at the 5 instead. In some trouble. He's going to be back, dropped for a loss inside the 5-yard line.
They're going to spot it right about the 4-yard line. They're giving you 4 progress.
At the 1. At the 1 is where they mark it.
Solano
should have let it go. It would have gone into the end zone for a touchback. Instead, now the Chicks are backed up at their 1-yard line, leading 6-0.
Well, George, we could say it could have bounced in there, but the way that that thing has been squirting around down there on that wet field, there is no telling what could have happened. But you know, and we had talked about that. John did mention about Jose wanting to do something to make something happen with it.
All right, leading 6-0, backed up now at their own 1 yard line. Got to hang on to the football here. Ferguson gives it to Braden Blakes. And
Blakes is on the sideline. That's going to be okay. Brandon Russell more than likely.
All right. They're going to give him forward progress to about the one, about the two, rather. So it's going to be second down and 9. The Chicks just want to hang on to the football here and give maybe Willits a little room to work with to get the punt away with under 5 minutes to go in the third, and the Chicks up 6-0.
I'd like to see him put Braden Blakes into the game and fake it to him and see Bob Ferguson maybe pop something out the far side of the field. That's where we got the touchdown on earlier.
Yeah, and no gain, they say. So call it second and 10, Chicks at their own 1 yard line. 9 men in the box for El Reno. Ferguson back to pass. He throws down the middle. Almost intercepted. Almost intercepted by El Reno's Seth Jones. No purple shirts were there. It's going to be third down.
That was a tough one. But you definitely, I didn't even think Coach Bray was going to pull that one out. So good job by him to keep the defense guessing. Need to complete that one the next time. And Jose Solano now split down to the near side.
So third down and 10 for the Chicks at their own 1. Quick snap, and there's Ferguson on the option play. Gets a big hole. He's got the first down at past the 10-yard line. What a great call, John. Or He's short of the first down by about a yard, but still a great, great carry there by Ferguson.
I say make that call again. Let's get the first down right here. Bob's running well. He's had positive yards just about every time he runs it up the gut, so let's see what we have here.
Fourth and 1 from their own 10-yard line, and a flag comes in.
False start.
Well, that's unfortunate for the Chicks. They were going to go for it.
Or a procedure. It's got to be a procedure.
False start.
They weren't even up to the line yet. I don't know how they can call that. They weren't even up and set and down in a stance yet, John. What's your thoughts on that one?
Well, I was looking over here at the sideline, so I didn't actually see the jump. But, you know, good crew of officials we have out here, so it's hard to fault them negatively on a play I didn't even see, Howie. How about that?
All right.
Line of scrimmage is the 5, so Javier Willits back at his own end line. Make sure you get a good snap back to him, so he can get a good kick away. 3:40 to go in the third. Chicks up 6-0. Fourth and 5. And it's a high snap over Willits' head. He's going to try to get the kick away. He does. It's going to be a low-lying kick. Takes a Chickasha bounce at about the 35-yard line. What great presence of mind by Willits. A high snap, but he gets it down and, more importantly, gets the kick away and avoids the safety and
avoids a fumble for a touchdown. There's so many things that could have happened on that play that were horrible, and the best of all of the outcomes happens as Chickasha gets the ball out to their own 35-yard line. I think that was probably the best of all of the situations you could hope for there on a fourth down play.
30-yard punt, no return. First and 10, El Reno at the Chick 35-yard line. 3:24 to go on the third. Hockersmith, the toss sweep to the tailback, gets a block. He's to about the 20-yard line, make that 30-yard line.
Clayton Mosley in there to stop the Comet on that one. Good job, Clayton Mosley, getting some penetration in there. His uniform's almost too clean for the way he plays.
Almost, yeah. Gain of 4. El Reno's only got 3 first downs for the game, but their first drive this half started at the Chick 44-yard line and a nice kick return after the Chick touchdown. And then after the Chicks were backed up inside their 5-yard line, a nice punt by Willits, but still out to the 35 of Chickasha. So second and 6 from the Chick 31-yard line. Pro set. They fake the toss sweep, and Hockersmith keeps it, and he's going to go over the right side inside the 30 to about the 25. There is some flag down, though.
That's probably going to be holding. That's thrown right at the line of scrimmage, and that's going to be a hold against El Reno. That'll bring that one back 10 yards. So that'll be a second down and 16 here coming up for the El Reno Indians. And good thing they had a pretty decent hole up the middle. That was a nice little play there for the quarterback for Hockersmith, and that's the first time that he has kept that one all night.
John, you got to love the defensive intensity for the Chicks. Again, holding El Reno to just 3 first downs. But especially here in the second half now, since El Reno's had their best field position.
Yeah, set up by that Great punt by Xavier. Might have been the play of the game, but yeah, the defense has played well. I'm not sure how many first downs they had in the first half, but one or two, I believe.
Just two. Here's third, or make that second and 15. Hawker Smith's going to throw deep. It's intercepted by the Chicks.
Devin Pinkston, Johnny on the spot down there, jumped up and picked that one out of the sky. That was a great play down there by Devin, and good job down there, Mr. Pinkston. He is a senior and making a big-time play. He wants his name on Howie's Final Four for Player of the Game tonight.
2:20 to go, and the Chicks get their first turnover of the second half. A nice interception there by Devin Pinkston, and the Chicks have it with 2:20 to go in the third, and the ball is at their own 23-yard line. Chicks take a 6-0 lead on that 46-yard touchdown run by Robert Ferguson earlier in the quarter. Solano split wide right on this first and 10 play, and Ferguson keeps it going over the right side. Past the 25,
to about
the 27-yard line. They still play after the whistle. Look out, guys. Play smart now.
That was actually Brandon Russell that had the ball.
All right.
Had been in their fight. I thought Robert had kept that one as well, and Brandon Russell is coming back from the tweaking that ankle at the end, towards the end of the second quarter.
A three carry after the 27-yard line, so we'll call it second down and 7 with under 2 minutes to go in the quarter. Chicks going from left to right. Not much of a breeze here. Thibodeau in motion. And it's Ferguson on the keeper over the right side. Gets out to the 30-yard line before he's stopped there. But some positive yardage. I don't believe, has Ferguson been sacked tonight? I don't think so.
He's had a couple of times where he's been about to get hit in the mouth on a passing play. But he's been able to get rid of the ball just in the nick of time.
Gain of 4, so call it 3rd and 3 from the 29, and they go right up the middle and an easy first down. The Chicks controlling the line of scrimmage, John.
Yes, they are, and you know that's been one of the first times all season they've been able to do that. You can see the positive energy and good leadership by all the seniors. Every one of them wanted to take advantage of opportunities. Devin Pinkston coming up with a big pick there. It's great to see these kids flying around offensively and defensively.
And to be in a game this late in the contest. The ball is spotted at about the 34-yard line where it's first and 10. Thibodeau in motion. The toss to Thibodeau to the right side. Gets a block. He's down to the 40-yard line and out past the 42. A nice block downfield there by Larry Abram into the Chick lineup. And we've got some extracurricular activities. But
I think they're just all jacked up down there. Number 73 from El Reno, Josh Kastrup, the senior for the El Reno Indians, came over here and tattooed our ball carrier, David Thibodeau. And we had Larry Abram over here throwing a big block, and Jose Solano as well. And just they were just excited down there, just some tough football.
Out to the 42-yard line, a quick snap, and Ferguson on the keeper gets the first down out to about the 45-yard line. And with 13 seconds to go, they're going to call an official timeout here. And let's see, he's going to be very close to the first down. Looking at it, and they're going to go ahead and call a first down for CHS, just short of the 45-yard line.
No sense in getting your feet wet any more than they already are. Might as well call a first down.
That's right. 11 seconds to go in the third, and the Chicks move the chains. Sixth play of the drive, starting at their own 23 after the Pinkston interception. And El Reno jumps off sides, no call. Ferguson's going to be under duress as he scrambles to the right, gets a pass away intended for Abram. And a pass is going to be incomplete. That stops the clock with 0.1 seconds left. A lot of pressure by El Reno on Ferguson that time.
Yeah, I think if they're going into the south end zone and the play clock they can see, but the game clock he couldn't. And I think if he could have seen the game clock, he probably would have just came to the sideline on that one.
Because they did take a relatively fast snap count there. So second and 10. This will be the last play of the quarter. As Ferguson under center on the second down play. And minimal gain on that play. And that's going to be the end of the third quarter. Fighting Chick 6, El Reno nothing. We'll be back after this timeout on 106.1 The Ranch.
From burgers and breakfast to chicken and ice cream, your Chickasha Sonic Drive-In has what you want when you want it. From the regular Sonic Burger to the Supersonic Bacon Double Cheeseburger and the Chili Cheese Little Doggy to the Footlong Chili Cheese Dog. From a Route 44 Coca-Cola to the Kevin Durant Candy Slushes and a Simple Sundae to the Chillin' Sonic Blast, Sonic has you covered. Still with half-price soft drinks during happy hour every day from 2 to 4. This is how you Sonic.
Southern Plains Medical Center, SPMC, has been providing quality health care to the residents of Southwest Oklahoma for 100 years. And SPMC offers general surgery, internal medicine, lab and radiology, and many other services that others cannot offer anymore. In Anadarko, the Physicians Hospital offers Caddo County residents health care and vision care with the Advanced Eye Center in downtown Anadarko. Together, Southern Plains Medical Center and the Physicians Hospital Anadarko, proudly serving the residents of Grady and Caddo counties.
Or work.
No.
CHS Football on 106.1 The Ranch, a presentation of Ben Milam Heating and Air Conditioning, the Chickasha Clinic Pharmacy, and Wing Tees. Chickasha 6 and El Reno nothing. We want to say hi to Mark Rath, who is tuning in tonight. Mark, thanks for listening, and hope you're enjoying the broadcast wherever you might be listening. Chicks will have it 3rd and 10 from their own 45-yard line. Some other scores to pass along. Minko has a big lead on the road at Community Christian. And Clinton 28, Woodward 7. Dibble 13, Lexington 8. Here's the 3rd-and-9 play for the Chicks. It's an option play to the near side. It's Abram gets it. Got down some downfield blocking, but it broken up and gets again out to about midfield on a nice tackle there. Abram with some downfield, Thibodeau with some downfield blocking, though, and Abram cooks up about 5 yards. It's going to be 4th-and-5. The Chicks look like they're going to go for it.
I don't blame them. The kicking game is a little too crazy tonight, so they're checking the wristbands and coming to the line too wide and one tight.
Abram in motion, and again, El Reno's going to jump off sides. They've done that 2 or 3 times. That should give the Chicks enough for a first down.
Can't say enough about the fighting Chicks staying disciplined down there, because even though you know that's what you're trying to do, when the quarterback comes with that hard snap count and gives that extra hut, it's sometimes you just, out of your reflexes, you just go. And propers to down there to the fighting Chicks O-line.
Moves to the El Reno 45-yard line, 1st and 10. For the Chicks there, they lead 6-0. This drive starting at their own 23-yard line. Ball on the near side hash, and here is Brandon Russell trying to bounce outside. He does so. Flag is down, though, as Russell advances to the 40-yard line. Then a second flag comes in, so holding probably the first flag.
I think Robert Ferguson, John, I don't know if you saw him, but after he pitched the ball, he went and he looked for somebody to lay a hat on down there.
Yeah, you know, he's not your average pencil neck back there. Bob is a football player. It's nice to see down there. That's one of the intangibles I believe we've been missing all year. Downfield blocks by the receivers, carrying out your fakes by the quarterbacks, open up big plays down the field, and Bob brings that to the table.
Holding is the call against the Chicks. That'll move it back to about their own 45-yard line. It'll be 1st and 20 from there. But the Chick defense has held El Reno to just 3 first downs tonight, each team with 2 turnovers. There's the snap. It's a Wildcat formation. It's a reverse. The ball comes out, though, and El Reno falls on it at the Chick 40-yard line. They tried a little trickery there with Abram and Thibodeau on the reverse. Thibodeau never did get the ball, and El Reno falls on it at the Chick 40.
It's tough to do that late in the game on a sloppy field. We're in the fourth quarter, and those balls, they were trying to keep them dry, but that's basically mission impossible on a night like tonight, and just a dangerous play down there. But I understand why they're doing it, because the El Reno Indians, their defense, they are in hot pursuit, and so you call a play like that to slow down the pass rush, slow down the run blitz. And had they hung on to that one, they had some wide open field over there on the other side.
1st and 10, El Reno at the Chick 41-yard line, going from our left to right. And we've got a timeout with 10:55 to go in the game. And it's an El Reno timeout. We'll step aside to Chickasha 6, El Reno nothing. You're listening to the Fighting Chicks on 106.
In this country, we love liberty.
And in Chickasha, we love Liberty Drug. Experience a pleasant small-town atmosphere and Chickasha's only old-fashioned soda fountain. Enjoy a drink while you wait. And take a look at Liberty's boutique t-shirts from Jadelyn Brooke and Charlie Southern. Liberty Drug is family-owned and operated and features Salt Lake candles, fun holiday decor, and a local pharmacist you can count on. Compare their service and your wait. Copay remains the same. Go fightin' chicks from Liberty Drug. Open weeknights till 6 and Saturday until 4:30.
To a trained comfort specialist, cool summers, cozy winters, and an energy bill that's light as a feather, no matter the season. Because your comfort is a matter of opinion, and with a trained comfort specialist on your side, it's also a matter of fact.
Dependability, reliability, longevity. That's what your trained dealer affords you and your home. Call Ben Milam today at 224-4314.
It's hard to stop a trained comfort specialist.
El Reno football, first and 10 from the Chick 40-yard line after the fumble recovery. And the Chicks lead here 6-0, a team that put 84 points on the scoreboard against Northwest Classen. Scoreless here tonight. Screen pass, might be a lateral, it's complete. And inside the 35, about the 32-yard line, El Reno's going to be very close to the first down there with a pass completion to Braxton Flick.
That's a come out in a bunch of formation they had. Basically a diamond formation of wide receivers over there, and you throw it to the guy at the very back of that, and he's got three guys already set up in blocking formation, and that's a good pickup over there for El Reno to bring up a second down and one.
Indians will split Gage Arnold to the far side of the field for Hawker Smith under center. Second and one. Now they send four receivers to the far side with an empty backfield. Hawker Smith, a lateral pass. They're going to go with a receiver pass downfield. It's going to be interference on the Chicks. Devin Pinkston going to be called for pass interference.
Oh, man, that one hit Devin. As soon as he did it, he knew he shouldn't have. And that was basically a double pass. They threw it backwards to the wide receiver, and then he threw it down to number 80. That was 22 down there streaking down the sideline, which is their big play receiver, Tony Evans, and Devin just shoved him to the ground. If Devin would have turned around and looked at that ball, he probably could have intercepted that one.
Unfortunately, it's going to be a big 15-yard penalty against the Chicks. And actually, yes, here they do march off the penalty. It'll be a first down, and El Reno has their deepest field position of the game.
Putting it on the 16-yard line there will be a first down and 10 at the 16.
Just their fourth first down of the game. 10-10 to go. Chicks up 6-0. Two receivers right for El Reno. The toss sweep to the tailback and breaks a tackle to the 15 down to the 10-yard line. Some hard running there for El Reno. Clayton Mosley helping out on the tackle there. And it's going to be a gain of about 6 down to the 10-yard line, so call it second down and 4 from there.
El Reno doesn't care that this is senior night for Chickasha High School. They want to win this one just as bad. Their next game next week is going to be a very tough one for them, so they want to get a W here tonight as well.
Two receivers right at the Chick 10-yard line. It's a running play again.
Bumble.
And the ball comes out at the 10-yard line.
Chicks
say they've got it. Howie says they've got it. The referee says they've got it.
Trace Brantley on the fumble recovery. That thing squirted out. An El Reno player tried to hop on top of it, and that thing is like a Mexican jumping bean down there. It's so wet and squirted out. And Trace Brantley, and there's another Fighting Chick down there on top of that one as well. Good job down there. Fighting Chicks forcing a turnover, John Mulder.
They are due for a turnover to go their way in a big play situation. They've battled them all year. Seems like they've gone the opposite way. Chicks come up with a big one there.
At least the third turnover for El Reno tonight. But the Chicks, again, backed up in their own territory at their own 10-yard line. Abram in motion. And it's Ferguson, the keeper, gets a big ball to the 20. 25, 30, comes to the near sideline. 35 and 40. And down at about the 47-yard line. Touchdown-saving tackle there for Jason Holmes. But Robert Ferguson from the 10 out to the 47-yard line, 37 yards.
Boy, he popped that, blew that one just wide open. He outran every one of his blockers. Jose Solano was doing everything he could to come down here and throw a block and couldn't get there fast enough. Good job there by the Fighting Chicks to spring that one big. Offensive line doing the work down there in the mud.
And gets them out from deep in their own territory. Now out at midfield is Ferguson got to be approaching 100 yards rushing here tonight. He did have that 47-yard touchdown run earlier in the half. That went for 37, so those two plays together make up for about 83 yards. First and 10 from their own 46. Screen pass over the head intended for Jose Solano.
They call that one incomplete. Yeah. Boy, that was really close to being a lateral. And El Reno's reading that one. They had a defender jumping up in the air trying to swat that one down, and that's a dangerous play when they're trying to key on it.
Second down, Chicks. Douglas 16, Blanchard 6. That game in the fourth quarter now at Douglas. Chicks lead 6-0 here, trying to get a home win tonight. And it would be their only home win if they can hang on to win this one here. Second and 10. Option play. Ferguson with the toss, but it comes out. Somebody's got to jump on it, and it's still loose. And it's picked up by El Reno at the 33-yard line. You got to just fall on it, guys, and just to keep possession instead of giving El Reno a chance to take it. And El Reno gets it there, and the ball's going to be at the 34-yard line.
Sometimes you got to, when there's nothing, and Bob's trying to make something out of nothing. And, John, that was definitely a nothing play where maybe he should have just hung on to it and not pitched it.
You're right. He probably should have held on to that. But, the running back's got it. Once he notices that ball's on the ground, you got to make a better effort to try to scoop it up and jump on it.
I think he thought it was going to trickle out of bounds as close to the out-of-bounds line as it was.
From the 33-yard line, El Reno, first and 10. Moving the line forward to about the 30-yard line before the Chicks push him back the other way, but it's going to be about a 3-yard gain for El Reno.
Brandon Russell coming up off the bottom of that pile, as well as number 65, Kobe Powell. And that thing, that was some tough running down there right into the meat of the Chickasha line, and brings up a second down and 6.
Both teams have worked on I don't like to say trick plays, but wrinkles that they've put in there. And you kind of saw that with the four receiver front out there trying to take advantage of Mr. Evans out there. So let's see what they do there here.
Chicks up 6-0. It is second and 6. Play action pass. It's complete to the 20-yard line and flung down there at the 19. And that's going to be Anthony Evans on the pass completion. El Reno picks up a first down, and they'll move the chains. They mark it at the Chick 19-yard line, a gain of 11.
That's just a good play right there, just a quick slant, and found the open guy in the zone, and Fight Chicks couldn't get there fast enough for a no gain, but a good gain there by the El Reno Indians, first down and 10 at about the 19-yard line.
Under 8 minutes to go. Hawker Smith to the line of scrimmage. I formation, man in motion through the line of scrimmage, and we've got a timeout, and a flag is down, actually.
Offsides on Fighting Chicks is what the linesman is calling over there.
That's their first offsides penalty here tonight for CHS. It'll stay first down. It'll be first and 5 now at the Chick 14-yard line. Chicks have had some stops inside the red zone against El Reno. But with just 5 first downs in the game, just their third here in the half. But certainly in it here. First and 5 from the Chick 14-yard line. Play action pass is going to be complete to the 5-yard line. The ball
fumble.
Comes out into the end zone. Just follow the football, boys. And the officials look at it, and it's going to be a touchback. Fighting Chicks recover the fumble.
John Mulder, we asked for some big turnovers at big times, and the Fighting Chicks are delivering down there.
Yeah, I think you can throw a bit of credit to Mother Nature. These sloppy field conditions certainly aren't helping these young men at all. But we'll take it any way we can get it. Nice job by the Fighting Chicks. Both teams, like you said, want to win. But fortunately, that one fell the Chicks' way.
Would have been a touchdown. He was a little bit short of the goal line. I thought he was going to get in, but the ball pops out of there. I didn't see who recovered the fumble. But the Fighting Chicks get another big break there. And they'll have the ball first and 10 at their own 20.
Yeah, that receiver over there was number 88, big tight end. That young man is pretty big size. He's about 6'2 or 6'3. And just hit him right in the hands and took a couple of steps, and then it squirted right out. A slick ball is hard to hang on to down there late here in the fourth quarter with 7:18 on the game clock to go in the game. Fighting Chicks up 6-0.
On a 46-yard touchdown run by Robert Ferguson early in the half. Here's Ferguson on the keeper and gets back to the line of scrimmage. Ferguson's a pretty sure-handed ball handler out there, and If he can break free like he has done a couple times, that'd be great. But
George, I hope you knocked on some wood up there when you said that.
Yes, you bet. Yeah, lots of it. All right, second and 10, Chicks from their own 20-yard line. One receiver to the near side. The ball comes out. That's a flag down, though.
That's going to be a false start.
Well, play getting a little sloppy here. The Chicks did pretty well in the first half, but I don't know if they're a little bit anxious and just want to, you know, just want to get the play started. But that's another false start penalty against the Chicks. Moves it back to the 15-yard line where it'll be second and 15 with 6:51 to go in regulation. And the Chicks up 6-0. Going from our right to left, no wind on a very wet Memorial Field here at Chickasha High School. Ferguson on the keeper, and not much there.
Was pulled down almost instantly right there at the line of scrimmage. That'll be a third down and long. Interesting to see what Coach Bray does here. They've done some passes here in some situations that he hasn't done it in the earlier in the season. So interesting to see what he has dialed up here for this third down and 15.
Chicks quickly come to the line of scrimmage. Solano split to the near side. They're going to give it to Braden Blakes. No, it's an option play to the 20 and out to the 24-yard line, just short of the first down. Great option play there by Ferguson on the keeper. Again, he does great on the misdirection. It's going to be fourth and long. Fourth and about seven at about the 24-yard line.
Javier Willits in to punt, and that ball, he come through there. I don't know if you guys noticed it, but that ball popped straight up in the air and fell right back down in Bob Ferguson's hands. And fortunate to hang on to that one.
The return man only at Chickasha's 45-yard line. Javier Willits at his 10. It's a low snap. The rugby-style punt will be a short one, and it'll take a Chickasha bounce out to about the 47-yard line. Only going to be about a 23-yard punt, no return. And with 5:23 to go in regulation, El Reno will have another possession to start inside Chickasha territory at the Chick 47. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to the Fighting Chicks on 106.
Chickasha's country music station, KWCO-FM, HD2 Chickasha, and translator K291BR Chickasha, 106.1 The Ranch.
First and 10, El Reno at the Chickasha 47-yard line. Chicks lead 6-0. Hawker Smith, the quarterback, he's gone the distance. Back to pass. Now he runs left to the Chick 45, 40, and first down before he's brought down. Just past the first down marker. The Chicks get the tackle there, but El Reno will move the chains.
Trace Brantley over there on the tackle. Braden Blakes flushed him out of the pocket, and then Jake Womack was chasing him in hot pursuit from behind. And Trace Brantley from his corner position able to make a saving tackle over there. And it looks like they're going to mark it just short of the first down, George. We'll bring up a second down and one.
At the Chick 37-yard line. Chicks up 6-0. Running play, and they runs into their own lineman, and the Chicks are going to stop him for no gain.
I'm glad they didn't throw it down here to 88 because he was this guy. He's a head and shoulders above Jose Solano, and Jose is not a short guy at all. And good job there by the Fighting Chicks, and that's a gratuitous spot there. And they're going to take time to measure on this one.
CHS football, a presentation of Chickasha Realty, Canadian Valley Technology, and Sonic Drive-In. George, Howie Jackson, John Mulder, Dennis Lynham here at Memorial Stadium, Bobby Mastin back at the studio. Hope you're enjoying our broadcast if you're here in Chickasha or listening anywhere around the world on 106.1 The Ranch, or maybe even you're watching. We hope you can do that. Short of the first down by about the length of a football with 4:26 to go. Anybody's ball game here. The Chicks lead 6-0. El Reno has it third and one from the Chick 37-yard line.
Look for them to go play action and go deep. They've got some threats in there at wide receiver, number 22 in the game. He doesn't have that limp that he had earlier. Tony Evans, watch for him here. He's a little bit dangerous. Then watch for Comet up the middle.
Two receivers right on third and long, and it's an option play. The quarterback keeper gets the first down easily and pushes the line forward down to the Chick 34-yard line for a first down.
Yeah, picks up about 5 yards right there, just going straight ahead, keeping it safe. The El Reno Indians are fighting Chick defense. looking to make a stand, and Braden Blake's out there talking to his troops right now, trying to get them fired up, letting them know, hey, guys, they want to win this just as bad as we do, but we got to want it more.
Only the sixth first down of the game for El Reno. First and 10 at the Chick, 34, with under 4 minutes to go now in the game. Here's Hawker Smith on the keeper over the left side. Gets a good gain, good blocking on the left side of the line. And positive yardage to about the 27-yard line.
They haven't done that too many times tonight, but when they've done it, John, it's worked pretty well for them.
It has, and it's a good pickup there. But, guys, if they keep them out of the end zone or keep them from scoring, the Chicks win the game. You need to let that clock run, get a big stop here, and not let that big 22 get a big play down deep.
Second and three. Back to pass. It's play action. The running back gets it. He's going to be stopped for maybe a short gain, and I believe that's going to be Tony Evans once again. They're going to spot the ball at about the line of scrimmage, the 27, so no gain. It's going to be third and three.
That was Comet on that run there, George. That was number one, the running back. He's pretty squirrely when he gets the ball. Third down here, important for the Fighting Chicks, third and three.
Under 3 minutes to go in the game. Back to passes. The quarterback, he's going to now run for it, and he may have the first down.
That's going to be close. They're saying he's down. They knocked the ball out of the hands.
He's about a yard short.
And John's got a pretty good eye on it down there. He's right on the line of scrimmage and says it's about a yard short. Going to be a fourth down and one here, and you know the El Reno's going to go for it. They're going to take time out to measure.
Very close down there. So we will see here with 2:45 to go. This one coming down to the wire. And the Chicks get a 46-yard touchdown run from Robert Ferguson to open up the second half of play. That's been all the scoring. Each team has turned the ball over here in the second half. And El Reno is going to be get a fresh set of downs here. They move the chains with 2:45 to go. They've got two timeouts remaining.
Yeah, it's important for – go ahead, John.
Guys, they've got some pretty generous spots a few times tonight. He was well short of the first down. I don't know how they come away with a first down on that one.
El Reno almost had a touchdown on their last possession, but they fumbled it at the goal line. The Chicks came up with the recovered fumble in the end zone. Here's the toss sweep of the running back. Gets to the edge to the 20-yard line, 18. The ball comes out. And it's going to roll out of bounds. It'll stay with El Reno.
El Reno tried to recover it and couldn't recover it cleanly, and it kind of squirted out of bounds there. And Coach Bray's hollering at the guys, come on, guys, we see that ball on the ground. We got to get on it down there. You know, they're doing everything they can. And even when they tossed that ball back there to the running back, Comet, he wasn't able to even grab the pitch cleanly. He bobbled it just a little bit. And that thing, it's late in the fourth quarter, 2:27 on the clock. Chickasha up 6-0 on El Reno, and that ball is still slick down there.
Gain of 7, so second and 3 from the Chick 17-yard line. Trying to go for the game-tying touchdown. El Reno back to pass. They throw short, incomplete. Incomplete. Intended for that big tight end, David Thibodeau, on the defense. And it was Cade Heilman, the intended receiver. It'll be third down and 3.
You know it's a good night when the referee lineman comes over and helps you pick a big old chunk of sod out of your face mask.
Now, Thibodeau's got more brown on him than I think he's got purple.
There's
right now.
No doubt. No doubt about that. All right. 2:23 to go. Chicks up 6-0.
Let's go.
One man splits wide left, and that is Anthony Evans.
He's in the slot.
All right, here we go. Third and 3. Back to pass. It's the toss sweep. They're going to be stopped short of the first down. A couple of yards short of the first down. It's going to be fourth down at about the 16-yard line. They're going to have a couple of yards to go.
Trace Brantley with a huge stop over there coming in from his corner position. Saw the running play and crashed down. Fourth down in the ball game here for the El Reno Indians. This will be a fourth down and a long 3, almost 4, and they will take their final timeout.
So we'll step aside as well. A minute 58 to go in regulation. Chickasha 6, El Reno nothing.
There are several reasons people buy their appliances at Joe's Maytag, but the main reason is simply their slogan, here to help. The professionally trained staff at Joe's are on the ball when it comes to showing you the ins and outs of your new kitchen and laundry appliances. They'll take all the time you need to make sure you know all the available features. And if you ever need their service, They are here to help. Joe's Maytag on Grand Avenue in Chickasha. Also serving the Anadarko and Tri-City areas.
Oh my gosh, ladies. Look at her shirt. It is so cute. I like cute shirts and I cannot lie. You other girls can't deny. When a girl walks in with a real cute tee, we all get that envy. So ladies.
Yeah.
Ladies.
Yeah.
Want to rock cute shirts?
Oh yeah.
Rock that. Rock that. Rock that Wing Tee shirt. We got you back at Wing Tees, 802 West Chickasha Avenue.
For crazy First National Bank. Stop by one of our 11 locations to learn more. This CD rate special is offered for a limited time only. Both the annual percentage rate and the annual percentage yield are 1%. First National Bank, member FDIC.
Fourth down and three for El Reno at the 17-yard line. Under 2 minutes to go. Here's the toss. Smith, the quarterback, keeps it, and they're going to stop him short of the first down.
Colby Powell was one of the first ones in there, number 65, getting there and fighting through. Good job down there by the Fighting Chicks, and that was fourth in the ball game for El Reno. Coming up short, that's a huge turnover, swing of momentum for the Fighting Chicks. Just got to hang on to the ball now, John Mulder, and take this one to the house.
Yes, sir. The defense is pretty fired up down here. Hopefully we just keep it in Bob's hands, play some conservative football here, keep the clock moving, and get the W for Coach Bray.
There is an injury timeout for an El Reno player who was down on the field. But, John, talk about the defensive line and the pressure they were able to get on the quarterback. And Hawker Smith had a little bit of running room early, but it shut down early.
Guys, I mean, really, on those last four plays, you had players stepping up at all levels of the game, but they played well from the offensive line. Solano coming up, making a big hit, and number 23, forgive me.
Trace Brantley
with a big stop there, and the offensive line with a huge stop on that fourth down. They played fantastic football all evening long and played really well on that drive. Hopefully we can be smart here and get the victory.
Jason Holmes, the injured El Reno player, he's able to run off the field under his own power. The Chicks have the football first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. El Reno can only stop the clock one time. Chicks lead 6-0 with a minute 52 to go. And El Reno is showing blitz as Robert Ferguson has gone the distance as the Chicks try to double up their victory numbers here this year. It's the option play, Ferguson, and right up the middle, there's Braden Blakes out to the 30, 35, and 40, and out to the 44-yard line. A big first down carry for Braden Blakes.
I was about to say, when you guys were talking, all they have to do is pick up one first down, but when you pick up a huge one like that and stop the clock, they'll have to pick up another first down, and they don't want to take a knee out here. These seniors want to go to the house and score a touchdown, John.
Yes, sir. We need to get these chains set and get that clock moving. And, these seniors, that senior's doing great. Big run by Blakes there, and just can't say enough about the kid.
28 yards, first and 10, Chicks at their own 45-yard line. The 90 seconds left in this one. And maybe one more first down is all they need to go ahead and put this one in the books. El Reno shows blitz. Ferguson goes right up the middle and gets good yardage out to midfield. With a minute 15 to go, it's going to be second down at about 5. What a great defensive battle this has been. A lot of turnovers. Just one touchdown tonight, and we've seen some big plays on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, it's one of those nights you knew coming in ball security was going to be an issue. That the ball was going to be on the ground. It was just a matter of how many times and who was going to come up with it when it did. And Fighting Chicks were able to pick up their fair share off of the ground, and they gave up their fair share as well tonight, and just doing a good job trying to run the clock down here as much as they can with 5-4-3 on the play clock. Looks like they're going to take a timeout.
With the 37 seconds to go, that's the first timeout for the Chicks. So we'll step aside, too. Just got to pick up one more first down, perhaps, and we'll step aside. Chicks nothing, Chicks 6, El Reno nothing on 106.1 The Ranch.
Business owners, you're inundated with salespeople selling you on why their media is better than the guy that just left your office 5 minutes ago. Most of you understand the importance of radio advertising, but you're looking for avenues that will enhance your ad campaigns. Outdoor is the answer. Strategically placed billboards capture a large audience, and it's the most inexpensive per impression form of media.
And business development training, too. See their website, cbtech.edu, and follow them on Facebook and Twitter. Discover what CB Tech can do for your company.
We're back at Memorial Stadium. The Chicks take a timeout. Let's see if they have the clock management right here. There's 37 seconds left to go in the game, and it's second down and six for CHS. So they should be able to. El Reno does have a timeout remaining.
They're in victory formation here. Maybe not.
In motion is Abram. They get the ball to Braden Blakes over to midfield.
It looks like Bob hung on to that one.
Okay. And there's going to be a timeout,
El Reno,
it looks like. El Reno takes their final timeout with 28 seconds to go. It'll be third down and about five. Chicks are up 6-0. So they'll discuss this a little bit. But a scoreless first half between these two teams. Chicks had four red zone possessions and could not score in the first half. But they take their opening drive in the second half, 75 yards. Courtesy of a 46-yard touchdown run by Robert Ferguson. And that's been all the scoring. And it's a final from Glenpool. Tuttle 2, Glenpool nothing.
Doesn't matter.
Oh,
you just got to score one more than the other guy.
How about that? So we'll talk to Coach Brad Bella tomorrow morning over on our sister station, our Saturday morning coaches show. Tuttle Tigers finished the regular season unbeaten. And they'll get next week off before they head to the postseason. Congratulations to the Tigers.
Fighting Chicks are going to have, they got a third down and five here. And they're going to do their best to pick up this first down. But if they don't, as long as they stay in bounds, the clock should run out. 25-second play clock, and you have 28.2 left on the game clock.
They're going to add 3 seconds to the clock.
So that'll put 31 seconds. So just hang on to the football. That's all you want to do. And
5 seconds.
5 seconds, they say. All right. That's almost an eternity. The Chicks are just going to line up with everybody in tight. I wouldn't necessarily call it a victory formation, but El Reno is out of timeouts.
They're going to need to run around for eight seconds here.
All right. So everybody in tight, and Ferguson's going to be back to the 45-yard line, takes a knee there, and by the time they get everything reset, they will run out of time here. So we are under 25 seconds to go, and they haven't started the play clock yet. That's game off. Fighting Chicks are going to win this one 6-0, and they start the play clock with 13 seconds, and that's the end of the game as the Fighting Chick faithful that to brave the chilly and wet weather. Enjoy a home victory for the first time this year. Fighting Chicks over El Reno 6-0. Fighting Chicks improved to 2-7 and pick up their second district win of the year. El Reno falls to 2-7. And the Fighting Chicks will be at Del City next week for their next football game. And El Reno will get to host the top-ranked Lawton Mack Highlanders. 6-0 our final. We'll be back with a recap and our Chickasha Lumber Company player of the game when our coverage of CHS football continues on 106.1 The Ranch.
There are several reasons people buy their appliances at Joe's Maytag, but the main reason is simply their slogan, here to help. The professionally trained staff at Joe's are on the ball when it comes to showing you the ins and outs of your new kitchen and laundry appliances. They'll take all the time you need to make sure you know all the available features. And if you ever need their service, they are here to help. Joe's Maytag on Grand Avenue in Chickasha, also serving the Anadarko and Tri-City areas.
Oh my gosh, ladies, look at her shirt. It is so cute. I like cute shirts and I cannot lie. You other girls can't deny. When a girl walks in with a real cute tee, we all get that envy. So ladies,
yeah.
Ladies,
yeah.
Wanna rock cute shirts?
Oh yeah.
Rock that. Rock that. Rock that Wing Tee shirt. We got you back at Wing Tees, 802 West Chickasha Avenue.
Small town feel and personality with tremendous selection. Chickasha Lumber Company is locally owned and perfectly located. Personal service, prompt, concise delivery, and a vast knowledge of the building industry sets us apart from our big box store counterparts. Products you know and trust, and the willingness to serve you, our neighbors, is a mighty combination. Old friends and new, we invite you to check us out today. Chickasha Lumber Company, 1620 South 4th, where service makes the difference.
By the Fighting Chicks, and the MO of them getting out of a game this year, has been giving up big plays. They play real tight and do a good job, and some big busted plays have been equaled some scores as the seniors are out here slipping and sliding in the mud.
How about that?
And looks like a 40-foot slip and slide out there for all the senior guys. Just don't do anything dumb, guys. You got another game.
I want to see John out there doing that.
John Mulder, are you out there about to do the slip and slide, or you got Coach Bray?
If Coach Bray will do it, I will follow.
Oh, there you go. All right. Great way to finish up the home schedule. It's been a rough year, and let's see if go ahead, John.
Coach, do we need to let you do the slip and slide in the mud here before we start this interview?
No, I'm good. My wife wouldn't let me in the house.
Congratulations, Coach. I know it's been a tough season for you, but your seniors really, as a unit, played well tonight.
Yeah, man, they were awesome. Hey, defensively flying around, I tell you what, Robert Ferguson came in at quarterback after being hurt for a long time and did a great job. I mean, I'd like to score more than six, but we couldn't kick field goals because it was so wet. We couldn't plant, and that took some points off the board for us, you know, Sterling being such a good kicker. But, man, these guys are gritty. They practice hard every day. They deserve it. What a game. It's fun.
I know you like to put more points up, but you told your team at halftime they don't score, they don't win. Shutouts got to feel nice too.
Yeah, I mean, our defensive guys do a great job, and they scouted El Reno up pretty good. That's a good football team. Like I said before, they're just in the same predicament as us. We just play great, great football teams week in and week out. So it's hard to get a victory in this conference, and this district is so tough. So we'll take it any way we can get it.
Well, Coach, do you have any thoughts on player of the game? You had several guys played well tonight.
Golly, I mean, it's hard not to say Braden Blake's every week. He just seems to come up with so many big tackles and that big run to get us out of the goal line. And to ice the game was just huge.
All right, Coach. Well, we'll let you enjoy your victory. Congratulations. And one more game next week.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks, Coach, and thanks, John. 6-0 Chickasha fighting Chicks win it in sloppy conditions here. Memorial Stadium. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more postgame in a moment. You're listening to the Fighting Chicks on 106.
Jake's Rib is Chickasha's premier barbecue restaurant. They've been serving up generous portions of delicious barbecue for 30 years and invite you and your family and your sports teams to stop in for heaping portions of hickory smoked ribs, sliced beef and pork, pulled pork, as well as steaks, chicken, and fish. Check out their daily specials and be sure to save room for cobbler. Ask Jake's about catering your special event. Jake's Rib, the only barbecue restaurant in Chickasha, open 7 days a week.
John Holt and Chickasha, where the deals are real and the prices are low. John Holt and Chickasha, when it comes to cars and trucks, John knows the only place to go for the best deal is John Holt. John Holt Chevrolet, where the hottest thing to do is pick your favorite color.
Chickasha. Chickasha Realty, matching quality people with quality homes. Here's a beautiful 3-bedroom home at 802 South 12th. There's an above-ground pool, a putting green, and 3 baths. It's priced at $184.5. Or see this adorable starter home at 711 South 18th. 2 beds, 1 bath with hardwood floors, large rooms, and plenty of storage, now just $74,000. For more on these and other great properties, call Chickasha Realty, 224-4298.
New in the local banking industry. It's the Community Bank of Oklahoma, which now serves the Chickasha, Vernon, and Newcastle areas. While the name is new, the bank's operated by your friends and neighbors whose families live here. They support local schools, sports, and ag programs, along with projects and activities that benefit their communities. Featuring a full line of banking services, Community Bank of Oklahoma provides competitive rates and unequaled service. Looking forward to being part of a thriving community. Community Bank of Oklahoma, member FDIC.
Wondering what to do over the next 2 years and beyond? Let Canadian Valley Technology Center give you a jump start on your education. Whether you plan to go on to college or immediately enter the workforce after high school, Canadian Valley is your ticket to a successful career. No matter where your interests lie, health, computers, transportation, or engineering, Canadian Valley has something for everyone. You can even earn college credit in many of our full-time programs. So sophomores, get ready. We'll be by your high school very soon. Canadian Valley Technology Center, securing futures.
Memorial Stadium, George Plummer, Our good friends Howie Jackson. How about when we've been working together? Howie, I still can't get your name right when it comes to crunch time.
I've been called worse.
I bet so. All right. John Mulder, Dennis Lynam here. Bobby Madison back in the studio. Chickasha 6 and El Reno nothing. Just a recap of the second half. Scoreless after the first half. Chickasha had the football to start the third quarter. Went on a 75-yard scoring drive, guys. It took 8 plays in 2 minutes and 53 seconds. A nice 46-yard touchdown run by Robert Ferguson put the Chicks on top. The PAT was no good, and the Chicks led 6-0. El Reno would get the ball about midfield on a nice return, pick up a first down, and would punt the football away and would pin the Chicks back their own 1-yard line with 5 minutes to go. The Chicks would get out to about the 10-yard line and would punt the football away. And El Reno had the ball at the Chick 35 with about 3.5 minutes to go. 2 plays later, Devin Pinkston with a big interception to give the Chicks the ball at their own 23-yard line, about 2 minutes 20 seconds to go. The Chicks would string together a couple of first downs, and the third quarter would end with the Chicks leading 6-0. And then, the Chicks would get a penalty on fourth down to extend their drive, but the Chicks would fumble, and El Reno would recover at the Chick 41-yard line with about 11 minutes to go. And then the Chicks get flagged for pass interference, and El Reno works down to the red zone, down to the 10-yard line. It looks like El Reno was going to get a touchdown, but there was a fumble, and the Chicks recovered in the end zone for a touchback. And that was a big turn of events there, Howie.
That was huge. We were calling. We were saying that they needed to force a turnover and get a turnover, and that's exactly what they did a couple of times down there on that end of the field. El Reno driving and fighting Chicks coming up with a fumble recovery and then that fumble recovery in the end zone. And their big tight end was a step and a half away from making a touchdown to tie up the game, but fumbled the ball, and fighting Chicks fell on it in the end zone for the touchback.
All right. The Chicks get the football, and Robert Ferguson gets them out near about midfield, but then the Chicks will fumble and give it back to El Reno with about 9 minutes to go. And then the Indians will pick up a first down to get down to the Chick 19-yard line. I think that's when the actual the drop touchdown pass occurred. It was Trace Brantley that recovered a fumble on the previous series that allowed the Chicks to take over first and 10 at the 10. And then there was a big 37-yard run by Robert Ferguson to get out to your midfield. And then came another fumble that El Reno recovered. And they got down about the 15-yard line, and El Reno, a great great throw and catch there. And I think the El Reno player was trying to just make something happen there at the goal line. The ball popped out, and the Chicks recovered in the end zone.
Yeah, you know, you can't fault the El Reno kids' effort. I thought they had several kids that played hard all night. Number 5 seemed to be the playmaker for them, flying around. Their big wide receiver, number 22, was hampered early and never really seemed to be able to get it going. But the Chicks' defense, you got to credit them, played aggressive, played well. Didn't have any foolish penalties tonight. We had a couple of, you know, pass interference, a couple of offsides, that sort of thing. But they were mostly effort kind of penalties, not really anything that took them out of the ball game. And you know, you get nervous whenever the game gets down 6-0 like that, and tight, just hoping that the game ends with us victorious. But credit to all the seniors. They played well, played tough, and they came out with a victory.
Yeah, I felt like that whole fourth quarter was played on our side of the 50, and we were either pinned up deep or El Reno was driving deep, and it felt like that whole fourth quarter was on that south side of the 50-yard line.
Yeah, there were 3 consecutive fumbles there on consecutive series there. After the Chicks got the fumble in the end zone, the Chicks got the ball at the 20, would work out to about the 24, would punt the football away, and El Reno got the ball near midfield with about 5:23 to go, and they would pick up a couple of first downs and get to about the 17-yard line. They got 7 yards on first down, got down to the 17-yard line, and would get no gain. And then 4th and 3, the Chick get a big stop to force the turnover on downs and basically run out the clock from there, John.
Yeah, you know, as you were talking, George, I was just looking over the long list of seniors the Chicks had tonight, and the large majority of them had big plays in this game. I mean, you could tell they all really wanted to play. Solano coming up, he was the kid who got his head on the ball to cause that fumble late that rolled out of bounds. Devin Pinkston making the big interception there a few times. Of course, Braden Blake, you know, he's been their workhorse all year long. I thought he played phenomenal tonight. And Bob Ferguson, I mean, stepping in at quarterback for the first time this year. And I don't think the coaches could have asked any more than what they got out of Bob tonight.
We got one more break to take.
Let's take one more break, and we'll be back to talk more about this game, a 6-0 win for the Chicks. And again, we'll also pick our Chickasha Lumber Company player of the game, and we'll check some other scores, too, around. You're listening to the Fightin' Chicks on 106.
Hey, dude, will you toss me a Dr. Pepper?
Here you go.
What is this?
A bottle of soda.
Did I ask for a bottle of soda?
Well,
no! I asked for an ice-cold, delicious Dr. Pepper. This is not a Dr. Pepper. Dr. Pepper is like throwing a game-winning Hail Mary. Other sodas are like punting on third down. This so-called soda is sillier than a mascot in a marching band. So when I ask for an ice-cold bottle of Dr. Pepper to watch football with, the one-of-a-kind taste of Dr. Pepper is what I demand. Dr. Pepper, always one of a kind.
Today's business owner isn't tied to a desk. Lots of our business customers at First National Bank tell us they're on the go. So whether your business is small, maybe you mow lawns or teach piano, or your business is much bigger with many products to sell, give us a call at First National Bank and let us show you the amazing potential of Pocket Pay. Pocket Pay lets you take credit cards on your smartphone, whether Android or iPhone, from anywhere. We can come to you and demonstrate Pocket Pay. Make your business as mobile as you are. First National Bank, member FDIC.
Let's check some scores from Class 5A. Of course, Chickasha beats El Reno tonight 6-0. Altus over Duncan 21-9. And Lautenbach over Dell City 37-0. Those are the district scores that we have. Checking District 5A2, we have Guthrie over Carl Albert 28-17. And in the eastern side of the state, Durant over Noble 48-34. And it was Piedmont. It's Piedmont over Guymon 13-7. And that game is in the fourth quarter. So those are some 5A scores. Ardmore beat Northwest Classen tonight 55-7. And checking the schedule next week, John, we know Chickasha's at Deer Creek. Ardmore at Duncan. Could be
Dell City. Dell City, the D.C.
What did I say?
Deer Creek. But
Well, D.C., Deer Creek, Dell City. But thanks for catching me on that.
With Dell City losing tonight and Duncan playing Ardmore next week, it'll be a tough task for Duncan to come away with that victory, I believe. And so Chickasha could play spoiler for Dell City next week if they can ride this wave of positive momentum. I'm assuming that Bob will be their quarterback next week. They seem to have found something there. And it's just a shame that it took a little while for him to get healthy. And, really these seniors seem to be healthy. I know Thibodeau, not a senior, but Thibodeau was banged up tonight. Brandon Russell banged up late. He really wanted to get it in there and make something late happen. But unfortunately, he wasn't able to go. Had that big run. The high ankle sprain has been nagging him all year. But getting back to that, I know the Chickasha will have a lot on game film to review, a lot of positive things to look at, and give Dell City something else to work on this week, and should be a good game.
No doubt about that. Let's check some 4A scores. Weatherford over Elgin, 20-0. Clinton beating Woodward, 42-7 with 5 minutes left in that ball game. Elk City and Cash were tied at 7. And Anadarko over Newcastle, 35-7. A win by Anadarko should wrap up their fifth straight district title. And Tuttle over Glenpool tonight, 2-0. The Kansas City Royals and New York Mets would be proud of that score. So how about that? All right, and Dibble was leading Lexington at last report in Class 2A, and that would be a nice win for the Dibble Demons. All right, let's check our Chickasha Lumber Company of the Player of the Game nominees, and there are several to choose from, gentlemen.
We've got, John alluded to him before we went to that last break, Devin Pinkston had the big interception down there on the north side of the field, and that was, we had talked about the punt coming out. Javier Willits barely got that punt away deep. We were on our own 1 yard line, got the punt away and out to the 35-yard line. And then in the very next possession, El Reno is going down into the end zone, and Devin Pinkston picks that pass off and changes the momentum of the game, and that helps out tremendously. Clayton Mosley 44. He gashed him up the middle early in the third quarter, and that is what really kind of set up some of the Chickasha offensive possessions in the second half.
Clayton had a couple of nice stops tonight as well.
Had some really big tackles. We always call Clayton's name on defense for making some big tackles. Devin Pinkston's always flying around, number seven. He's always got a nose for the ball. Braden Blake's, like Coach said, you could call him player of the game every game if you wanted to, and he came out on fire tonight from the get-go. And, John, I believe that because he is not the featured number one back now in the offense, that it's really given him a spark on defense.
Oh, I think so. I mean, you could tell, you could see it in his eyes before the game tonight that he was fired up and ready to play. He wanted the ball every chance he got, on offense or defense. He was just a wrecking crew out there. I think he was dirty from head to toe after the second play of the game. But I sound like the president of the kids fan club, and I just, you know, you see certain kids who work hard in practice. They do a pretty good job of being good citizens and just really letting it all hang out on the football field. He has really impressed me with his development from the beginning of the year to the player he is now. And I think he could really be – he's got the physicality to be a real force at the next level. And I think he's going to get some looks.
Yeah, he's standing down there right now talking to some of the other guys. And you see a college program pick up a young man like that and put 20 or 30 pounds on him and teach him – it's a little more quickness to go along with the speed that he already naturally has, and he could help somebody out for sure at the next level. And Robert Ferguson, senior quarterback, who was the original backup quarterback at the start of the year, got hurt before Jake Womack got hurt. Jake Womack, starting quarterback, goes down, so then they go to the third string quarterback, which was Tyler Thompson, and Tyler Thompson got hurt right after the Duncan game. And then they go to the fourth-string quarterback, who had never played quarterback at this level, David Thibodeau. And then Bob Ferguson gets healthy and comes in tonight, quarterbacks for the first time, puts the ball up in the air a lot more than we've seen all year, was under duress a lot, tried to make something happen. Every time he had the ball, was definitely trying to make something happen, and did have the lone touchdown of the game.
You know, he has a nose for the football. His freshman year, a couple of years ago, before I graduated to the broadcast booth, I had a chance to coach him at the freshman level and then assisted with the defense. And we really struggled with linebackers. Didn't have many linebackers that would step up, and we were throwing out names out there. His was the first name that I threw out there. And, you know, as a freshman, undersized kid, what do you like about him? I said, he just goes to where the football is, guys, and we need somebody to do that on defense. And you saw that on offense tonight. There were a couple of busted plays, and he didn't panic, just picked up the ball. He got what he could get, and a couple of times he had some pretty nice yardage. I think the quarterback position, you know, it's so critical. We talked about the footwork, the timing of the blocks and the running backs, and Bob just did exceptionally well tonight, stepping into a role, and he was on a mission tonight to – all the seniors were, really, but Bob is my nominee for player of the game.
Well, I'm going to go with Bob, too. I mean, playing, again, quarterback for the first time in game experience, the leader of the team offensively. I mean, has the ball almost every play of the game offensively. Didn't play on defense, but still just the way he managed the game and didn't – there were a lot better exchanges between center and quarterback tonight. And just had the big touchdown run, and just my vote's going to go to Bob Ferguson as well.
We talked about this off the air, a game ball to every one of these seniors, because
sure,
every one of these guys that we mentioned tonight, senior leadership. You saw Braden Blake's out there late in the game firing the defense up when they make the stop on fourth down. And on third down, he's getting them fired up, saying, hey, we need to stop this thing so we can win this. The seniors tonight. And they do a lot in practice. We might not call their game one time on a Friday night, but for those of you that have never been a part of organized athletics, when you're going against the scout team, that's sometimes, if you're running the scout team, that is your number one. That is your chance to shine. And so there's a lot of names that we might not call on the air, but there's a lot of young men down there that are doing it every day, day in and day out on the practice field to help this team get ready for Friday night. And game ball goes to the seniors, and my vote's for Bob Ferguson as well. He'll be the Chickasha Lumber Company player of the game. Did an excellent job tonight. And we knew there was going to be the ball was going to be on the carpet a lot. We knew that going in with it being a wet field and muddy. And I thought the Fighting Chicks did a really excellent job tonight of if the ball came out, they tried to hop on top of it as quick as they could.
We knew there weren't going to be any easy victories for the Chicks, and this certainly was no exception. But I thought they did really well of closing out the win and just fighting to the last second. And nice job. Congratulations to Coach Bray and company on the victory.
No doubt about that. And when it came down to crunch time, it just showed how well they could play with the game on the line. You know, pressure on. El Reno had the ball in the red zone several times late in the second half and could not score. The Chickasha defense made the big plays when it happened. So 6-0, the Fighting Chicks win it. And we will have one more game next week when we travel to Dell City for a Friday night game at 7 o'clock. We hope to see you up there at the stadium. If not, you can listen to the game right here on 106.1 The Ranch. Also, join us on our sister station tomorrow morning on Cool 105.5. We'll have our Saturday morning coaches show. We'll start off with Chickasha head coach Jerry Don Bray, and it'll be an hour of recaps of area games and interviews with area coaches. My thanks to my broadcast crew, Howie Jackson, John Mulder, Dennis Lynam, our videographer here at the station, at the field, and Bobby Mastin back at the studio. Our thanks to you, our listeners, and our sponsors, and we hope you've enjoyed the broadcast as much as we've enjoyed bringing it to you. Chickasha 6, El Reno nothing. Good night from CHS Memorial Stadium.